schedule. Oh, okay. Yeah, I drop the next segment.
If I airdrop,
choose for the library and drop them on.
All right. I appreciate y'all coming on. Our Patreons. We want to thank y'all for checking us out at this time. It's Divine Couple Night. Myself, my wife, Brother Earnest, his divine mate, Khamsin, and we get into some deep information for y'all dealing with this current event that is taking place with them trying to establish the so-called New World Order. And what is really going on, because as the supreme axiom states, as above, so below, as within, so without. All right, that's what we're going to be dealing with. And so we're going to get right into some heavy topics. But before I do, I got to give all due respect and honor to those who have passed over in the last week and a half. All right, we got to give our honors and due respect to Dr. Leo Africa, or Layola Africa. We have to give our respects and due to I'm a Zulu shaman, Credo Mutwa.
I say.
Yes.
Kalindi Fihi. We have to give due respect to Minister Abdul Hasfid Muhammad.
Yes. Right.
And we have to give our due respect to Master Rico Guy and Master Woodbury. All right.
Ashe.
These great brothers, not only health practitioners and shamans in their own rights, but they was also martial artists. Had a warrior spirit in which that is needed at this time. And it has been speculated that these brothers allegedly died of the coronavirus.
Wow.
So we're going to get into this information. I'm not going to deal with conspiracy theories, but we will be dealing with some deep information in which that is needed in order to put the pieces of this puzzle together.
All right.
We got to give all due respect, honors, and our ashes to the divine brothers that have passed on within just a week and a half, y'all.
Ashe.
As I start off, get into, when you look up the word vaccination and corona, they both equal, according to the Pythagorean numerology, 666. All right? C is 3, O is 15, R is 18, O is 15, N is 14, A is 1, which comes to the 6 letters in corona, and then, of course, 66 from the numeral add up or additions. And then, of course, when you do Pythagorean numerology for the word vaccination, it comes up also to 666.
Mm-hmm.
These are no coincidences, all right?
Right.
This is specifically to target melanated people, because all of a sudden they went from an airborne disease in which that was just targeting mostly Europeans, but now, as we just seen, it has now become a so-called black disease.
Yeah, the number of man too.
Mm-hmm.
Huh?
I said a number of man too, huh?
Right, a number of man. He who has wisdom, let him bear witness to the fact of 6 and 3 and 6, which is 666.
Exactly.
All right. That's Revelation, the 13th chapter. But also in the book of Revelation, the 13th chapter, it goes into something else too, which we're going to get into. Mm-hmm. But we're dealing with the corona. The real corona is your auric field.
Yes.
When your auric field is weakened, particularly in this case by radiation,
mm-hmm.
All right? Radiation poisoning. This is really what's going on with the 5G. If you get to the U.S. Naval Medical Research Institute, 1972, declassified, it speaks of the symptoms of radiation sickness, and mm-hmm. people been having headaches, that's mm-hmm. dizziness, nausea, difficulty concentrating, anxiety, memory loss, insomnia, mm-hmm. fatigue, tremors, mm-hmm. muscle spasms, tingling, otic reflex, muscle and joint pains, and also as is stated here, muscle spasms, the eyes, pressure behind the eyes, deteriorating of vision, all right, mm-hmm. and cataracts.
Mm-hmm.
All right. I remember one of the brothers that was staying with us, within just a matter of months, developed cataracts and couldn't see.
Wow.
You know, and that just didn't make any sense. So he had to go get eye surgery for the correction.
Wow.
Nobody put this together that it could have been radiation poisoning.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
Here we're looking at heart palpitations, arrhythmia, chest pains and pressure, low and high blood pressure, sinuses, bronchitis, asthma, pneumonia. All of this sounds similar to some of the things in which that they claim is coronavirus.
Mm-hmm.
Skin, the skin rashes, itching, burning, facial flushing, problems, abdominal pain, enlarged thyroid, testicular, and ovarian pain. All right?
All sorts of, man.
Wow.
Brothers, this is causing blue balls.
Mm-hmm.
This is what we used to call this back in school. We thought it was just, you know what I'm saying? Because you wasn't doing anything.
You know, right.
Mm-hmm.
This case here, this is radiation. And the main thing that you see here is dehydration. Now, remember, Dick Gregory always said that dehydration and sleep deprivation was the main cause of illness.
Mm.
This is why Dr. Sabi told us to at least drink 1 gallon of water a day.
Yeah.
Because you are being heated up by the radiation. And the heat and the radiation is causing dehydration. So you're waking up in the morning after a night's sleep because you still have that damn Wi-Fi on, and you're thirsty, and you're developing symptoms of diabetes.
Mm-hmm.
This is what it says right here. Immune abnormalities. And then it says altered sugar metabolisms. It's diabetes. You're getting the sugars, not just from the junk food that you're eating, but because you're being heated up and it is causing pressure upon your spleen, your pancreas, and your liver.
Yeah.
All right. Redistribution of metals within the body and hair loss.
Mm-hmm.
Coming from radiation poisoning. Now, this is radiation poisoning. Let's look at something right quick, because I want to say something, you know, before we get, you know, into some of the stuff that we're going to talk about. Right here, we have to look at, let me go up. Okay, here we go. So, this is one of the things. All right. So, if this thing is radiation poisoning, if this is the 5G, all right, of course, remember, they banned anyone who is saying that the 5G is correlated or is the coronavirus. Why is that? Why can't you state your opinion?
Mm-hmm.
Why are they violating your constitutional rights?
Yep.
No freedom of speech.
That's the question, right? So we find out that Corella binds to heavy metals. Remember, we just been saying that there's a redistribution of metals in the body because of what? Radiation poisoning.
Yes.
Here it is. Corella binds to heavy metals and radioactive particles.
Uh-huh.
And flushes them from the body.
Mm-hmm.
This is a powerful weapon in preventing the
death caused
by radiation.
Yeah.
Mm.
That's, and guess what? And to heal and to help speed up recovery of the body when damage has occurred. So Corella has the ability in order to cast off the negative effects of radiation poisoning.
Yeah.
Heavy metals at the same time.
Mm-hmm.
All right. Why? Well, let's look at it. Corella offers a natural approach to radiation protection. Nature's most potent source of chlorophyll.
Yeah.
And most nutrient dense than all other greens, including kale, spinach, and broccoli. Especially vegan source of protein, excellent vegan source of protein, 16 grams, vitamin A, 287% RDA, vitamin B2, 71% RDA, iron, 202% RDA, and zinc, 133% RDA per serving. 1 ounce per serving, that's just 1 ounce. What does it do? It boosts energy levels and help the body detox heavy metals such as mercury and lead. Now, mercury and lead. Now, that's deep because in the vaccines that they plan on giving you, along with that microchip that we're going to talk about, but along with what they're going to give you, guess what's inside of these vaccines?
Must have mercury, because they sure do use it as a preservative, so they say.
You got it.
Absolutely. And then, you know, Dr. Bay, the chemtrails, I went to get tested in Clearwater. Mm-hmm. Excuse me, y'all. I went to get tested in Clearwater, Florida, and found out that I had the highest amount of mercury he had ever found in a patient.
Wow.
And he asked me, where was I from? And I told him Memphis, Tennessee, and he said, you're not the first. And that was a clue to me that the areas that they spray more heavily probably are dealing with a lot more heavy metal poisoning.
Yep. Exactly. Exactly. Yeah. So this is why I'll be giving you off the bat the formula on what to flush out your system, the heavy metals and radioactive particles. Because guess what? When they give you the vaccines, because they're trying to make this mandatory. All right?
Mm-hmm. Right.
More into that in a second, but it helps produce healthy levels of glutathione, which is the most potent antibiotic or antioxidant in the human body. This is, this is a natural antibody, all right? Antibiotic, as they would say. In other words, this is a natural antioxidant to keep your body from rusting, because iron and water cause rust.
Yeah.
That's right.
All right, we know that the center of your blood cell is iron, and your body is 90%, 75% and up of water. All right, so it strengthens the immune system during radiation. That's what it just says. It strengthens the immune system even during radiation. Chemotherapy treatments. So, number one, you need Corella in your life.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
All right. I wouldn't be surprised if they start trying to
absolutely
make it hard to get.
Yeah. That's why we telling everybody now to go on and get it, bulk up on it.
Yeah.
We have it, you know, because we know that, you know, our people is going to need it. So, you know, we got, you know, what we could, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
When the people was ready, yo, they have a source instead of just,
right,
you know, mm-hmm, going somewhere and trying to get it, you know, especially, exactly, you know, they're telling people to stay in the house.
Mm-hmm. right.
All right, so let me come down.
Oh, yeah.
All right, so here, Corella offers a natural approach to radiation protection and heavy metal detoxification. These articles just keep going on and on and on because during, mm-hmm, World War II, after the dropping of the atomic bomb on Hiroshima or Hiroshima,
mm-hmm,
and, Nagasaki, the Japanese needed something in order to put their body back into order. They started taking Corella.
Yeah. Mm.
All right.
Yeah.
Years later, they are a world power.
That's true. Yeah.
All right.
Yeah.
Because they began to start taking Corella. We're going to have to do the exact same thing.
Exactly.
That's right.
Yeah.
All right. So, also, we talked about dehydration. Well, how do you hydrate yourself? Well, let's look at that right quick. You hydrate yourself. To stay hydrated, one of the things that you have to do, number one, staying hydrated is important for maintaining the function of every system in the body, including your heart, brain, and muscles. Now, the heart and brain are two of the locations, along with the genitalia, the testicular, which is your testes, and the ovaries, sisters. These are the areas that are being attacked in the body by these, by this radiation.
Yeah.
It says fluids carry nutrients to your cells, flush bacteria from your bladder, and prevent constipation. When consumed in a solution, Himalayan salt provides the body with electrolytes.
Mm-hmm.
Not, God damn it, drink.
Yeah.
What do you take when you're playing football, baseball, and basketball?
What's the G-Rate.
Exactly. They
power eight.
The
drinking that mess. Come from you sprinkling in your water and drinking it. This is what hydrates you. So some of the major electrolytes that the salt provides include sodium, iodine, potassium, and magnesium. Matter of fact, it has over 84. It has over 84 nutrients.
Wow! All the mineral benefits in that.
It is salt 84. Y'all can see that?
Yeah.
That's interesting. Because about 3 or 4 months ago, actually it's about 4 or 5 months ago now, Yemiya, this is when I really first started communicating with her energy, and she told me to tell everybody to start drinking Himalayan salt and warm spring water every day.
Perfect. Exactly.
Yeah. So this was preparation for what was coming.
Yeah, because I was told the same thing about pink Himalayan salt, and I posted it on Facebook.
Yeah,
it was 2 months ago.
Mm-hmm.
That they need to get it.
Yeah.
So right here on the back it says Salt 84 is the brand for our Himalayan pink salt, which contains up to 84 minerals and trace elements.
Mm.
All right. So this is. Remember, Dr. Sabi was telling everybody to drink sea moss, which has two of the minerals. Well, this pink Himalayan salt has 84 of minerals as sea moss.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
All right. So picture this in your water along with your sea moss.
Some Corella.
Right. And your burdock. And then, of course, your Corella. And also spirulina. All right.
Oh, yeah.
Yep.
Oh, yeah. Can't leave that one out.
Yep. spirulina.
Right. This is what we have. We have the combination of spirulina and chlorella.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
All right, Potter. You got to get these are the things on which that you have to have on a daily basis, y'all.
Yeah. I mean,
daily basis. Three times a day.
Okay.
All right. So drinking this solution just once a day can have very positive effects on the body. This is what it says about the pink Himalayan salt. Because in order to avoid the excess sugar from these sport drinks, just put some sprinkles, a little sprinkle in your water and drink that. All right. Mm. For those that have thyroid issues, goiters, problems with the thyroid gland, metabolism, obesity, you need Lugol iodine. Iodine is necessary. 90% of the population is
deficient.
Is iodine
deficient? That's what Dr. Ben put me on.
Yeah,
that's a fact.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Most of y'all got this salt in your house right now.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yeah.
What does it say though? It says this salt does not supply iodine,
mm-hmm.
a nutrient.
Yeah. So what the hell is it?
By design.
Yeah.
Right. Why in the hell are you eating salt that has no iodine?
That's crazy.
Mm. Iodine deficiency causes hypothyroidism.
Mm-hmm.
Access can cause it as well. So in the United States, iodine deficiency has historically been low, according to the World Health Organization. All right? So they go as far as saying 90% of the United States population is iodine deficient.
Mm-hmm.
Wow. Because you eating salt that does not supply iodine a necessary nutrient.
Yeah.
This is table salt. This salt is not this salt.
Yeah.
That's right. That's right.
So when they told you, oh, you got high blood pressure, and they told you not to eat salt, they meant this salt. That's
right. Exactly. Not this salt. Yeah.
Not this salt.
Yeah.
It'd take you from a table to a coffin.
Yeah. Right. Yeah. This salt here would give you energy and will correct high blood pressure. That salt here will have your ass in the coffin.
That's it.
That's right.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Coughing salt.
Right, coughing salt. Exactly. So it's no coincidence that exposure to the 5G waves,
mm-hmm.
same situations and same problems. We talked about iodine. When you look up iodine solution or iodine situation, let me read something right quick. Let me see. See if I can pull it up. Right. I'm gonna pull up something that's called iodine and why we need it. And I'm gonna give you some of the problems with iodine deficiency, and you're gonna see how iodine deficiency radiation poisoning.
Okay.
The same goddamn symptoms.
Yeah.
The same symptoms. Weakness, fatigue, hair loss, problems metabolizing your food.
Mm-hmm.
All of these are issues of iodine deficiency, but it's also of radiation poisoning. So that means the radiation poisoning is leaching the iodine from out your system.
Wow.
All right, can y'all see my screen?
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, I'm looking at the exposure to the 5G wave leads to flu-like symptoms.
Right. And also, okay, so iodine, why you need it and why you can't live without it. This is a book, right, by Dr. Brownstein, MD. So I'm just going to read something right quick. And I thought it was very important to correlate this information. All right. So let me see here. All right. So This is the thing. Oh, this is real. This is some real problem right here. What does iodine do? Check this out. For over 100 years, iodine has been known as the element that is necessary for thyroid hormone production. That means your T3 and your T4, which is produced from your thyroid glands and parathyroid glands, which also helps with your development of your white blood cells. Mm-hmm. However, it is rare to see any further mention of iodine other effects in the body. Iodine is found in each of the trillions of cells in the body. That means in all 76 trillion cells, iodine is supposed to be there. Without adequate iodine levels, life itself is not possible. Wow.
Right.
Wow. Iodine is not only necessary for the production of thyroid hormone, it is also responsible for the production of all of the other hormones in the body.
Wow.
Adequate iodine levels are necessary for proper immune function. Why are they saying that people are catching the Ronies?
But their immune system is not strong.
Da-da!
Wow.
Because they don't have sufficient iodine levels. Because 90% of the people in the United States are iodine deficient.
Yeah, wow.
Iodine contains potent antibacterial. Potent antibacterial. Parasitic, antiviral. What is the coronies? What is the Ronies?
A virus.
A virus. So iodine contains potent antiviral. Anti-cancer properties.
Wow.
So it states further that approximately 1.5 billion people, which is about one-third of the Earth population, lives in an area of iodine deficiency, as defined by the World Health Organization. And the iodine deficiency disorder can result in mental retardation.
Wow.
Increased child and infant mortality. Infertility. Socioeconomic decline. Iodine deficiency disorder is the most common preventable form of mental retardation known. Let's look at this. Therapeutic actions. We talked about it. Antibacterial, anti-cancer, anti-parasitic, antiviral. Elevates your pH levels.
It automatically elevates your pH levels.
Automatically elevates your pH levels. The conditions listen to this. The conditions treated with iodine. ADD, ADHD.
Wow.
Uh-oh.
Did you get
Arthrosclerosis, breast disease or breast cancer, the lymphatic system, lymph nodes, excessive mucus production. Oh wow! So you can't get the Ronies with mucus if iodine is present. That's the element that is in Dr. Sabi's formula, which is the bladder rack, which is the sea moss, and it's the iodine that helps you get back your body in order.
Yeah.
Fatigue. All right. So weakness and fatigue. Garters, hemorrhoids, headaches, and migraine headaches, hypertension, infections, keloids, liver diseases, all right, ovarian disease, testy disease, prostate disorders, thyroid disorder. Hold up. These are some of the same disorders that we just finished reading and that you can see that is listed on the radiation because 5G waves, which is radiation, leads to flu-like symptoms. What it says, headaches. Oh, wow, that's the same stuff we just finished reading.
Yep.
Uh-oh. skin rashes, itchy skin, muscles and joint pain, low and high blood pressure. Dehydration. Lymphoma, which is dealing with the lymph nodes.
Mm-hmm.
Let's go over. Memory loss, brain disorder. That's mental retardation. You see, all of this is correlating. ADHD and DD. Oh, wow. The same exact things in which that is caused by iodine deficiency, and the increase of the 5G causes the same symptoms. No coincidence. Okay? No coincidence. So, we're going to get more into that. We're going to get into this science here. And we're going to get into BETELGEUSE. All right? But we're going to get more back into this information. But we want to build on this right quick. And of course, you know, we're going to get the information on these BETELGEUSE because we kicked it off and how we linked up. The goddess hit me up like about 2 months ago when Kobe passed, and she told me her vision. And she told me that, you know, when she went into the astral plane, she got information concerning Kobe Bryant, and she found out about his books and how he was on the occult sciences.
Yeah.
So after she told me that, I went to go do some research, and I found the same information. And I'm like, yo.
He was on it.
Something was going on. And to me, the reason why they took him out, some say that he faked his death, I can't say, but to me, why they took him and his daughter out is because he wouldn't pimp her like Will Smith and Jada Smith does their children. And, you know, he walking around with a dress, he's kissing his father in the mall, TV shows, and he's being effeminized based off of the same thing that we read within the Willie Lynch book. Or pamphlet. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. Willie Lynch book or pamphlet was said to be done, had been done by a brother in Durham, North Carolina. And I actually knew the brother when brother Bruce Bridges had the bookstore open called the No Bookstore. He was there. But I know where he got his information from. He got it from Malcolm X History. If you go and get Malcolm X book on Malcolm X History, he speaks about a lot of the things that is in the Willie Lynch book. So it's historical information. He just put it, you know, into a booklet and said it came from a person by the name of Willie Lynch. But even in the book, it says that the males would be effeminized.
Mm-hmm.
Women would be masculinized I hope I'm saying that correctly, but would be... be independent. I don't need a man. While at the same time, the boys would be dependent, become mama boys, whatever. Yeah. And so this is the same thing that we've seen with Will Smith, and Jada Smith, their children. Yeah. All right. You know, so we see that Kobe Bryant didn't want to pimp his daughter like that. He was gonna make her into a boy.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yeah, saying, look, I'm a daddy's father. I'm a daddy's little girl father, or you know, however he was saying it. He was saying that, look, I'm going to teach, you know what I'm saying, these children, you know, properly.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. You
know?
Yep.
You know? Now what introduced me to the metaphysics, so many people were saying that the reason Kobe was being killed was because of the lawsuit that he was having with the pharmaceutical company.
Right.
However, it might sound crazy, and I'm just now getting comfortable with being public about some of my psychic abilities, but the night that he transitioned, him and his daughter woke me up at 3:00 in the morning, and my husband, I guess the lightning is attesting to the truth.
Right,
but But what happened was I woke up, this was my first time having experienced this strong, and I could literally hear him saying, write this down. Mm-hmm. So I'm up, I couldn't go to sleep. He kept me up until 6 o'clock in the morning. Mm-hmm. And what I knew was really his energy that was communicated with me, the truth. He's like, I gotta give you the truth to give to the people. I was teaching metaphysics to the young gods and goddesses, that was directed to the melanated gods and goddesses. And it was so crazy, as I was writing it down, I was like, I might have ate too much counter butter earlier today or something. I don't know what's going on. So I didn't think nothing of it. Woke up the next morning, did some research. His books was set to be all released in March of 2020.
2020, that's right.
And I went and read three of the books, because our son plays basketball. He's one of the top basketball players down here. And, you know, so we've been following basketball close. Of course, Earnest played too. So I'm reading through the books. What he did was he took the first five books of the Bible, the Pentateuch, and he rewrote the whole first five books of the Bible. Right. So the five books that were being released was him retelling the Old Testament in the way that it was given to him. And that's deep.
Yeah.
That's a bold move.
Now, that's no coincidence, being that we are now, today is Easter or Ishtar or Set Day, which is on the Book of Moses in Passover.
Yes, absolutely.
Yeah. Yeah. So all of this, Christ, everything is everything.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely.
You know, so right here, when I went to go the calendar year of the Ethiopians, we find that the current year, according to the Ethiopian calendar, is 2012.
Mm-hmm.
It says, this year, which will begin on September the 11th, 2020. So this is why they had to put the 9/11 scare in our asses.
Yep.
All right? 19 years ago.
Mm.
Right?
Yep.
September 11th, 2001, they had to put the fear in us 19 years ago. So, and the number 19 is very significant, all right? Because it's at 19 degrees, that our Kundalini has an upswelling of energy, right?
Absolutely.
And it's at, and that's south, at 19 degrees north, there's an upswelling of energy from our pineal gland. The number 19 is significant because it's called COVID-19.
Mm-hmm.
So you know, COVID-19 is the coronavirus disease. That was COVID means. And it's 19, allegedly, because 2019 is when it began, October 19th.
1 month after they got 5G up and going in China.
You get it. 1 month, right? Which was September.
September seems to be the portal month for a lot of their mass rituals.
Yeah, Virgo. Yeah. Virgo. Yeah.
Absolutely.
Right, that Virgo energy.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? That's the virgin, the birth.
Yeah.
That's right.
Right? And So what's going on? Virgo, astrologically, is the virgin, and the virgin is, of course, Aset, which, once again, that is the Asetian energy. So 2011 symbolizes, 2020 symbolizes the return of the Asetian energy. The Osirian energy is already returning, which is from Betelgeuse.
That's right.
To me, is the Osirian, Asetian energy.
Yes. Mm. Which was why we felt it was so important to have the pyramid behind us. Just our ancestors leading us and speaking to us, you know, our brains work with symbols. And we came to that understanding as well. But what's beautiful about it is that all set came to me, and all of this is documented on the channel. So, you know, I can't call to be saying that I'm doing this stuff and I ain't got nothing to show proof. But she came to me in the form of Isis in late August. And she said to me that a rebirth was about to begin among the people, but death would be required.
Right.
And I didn't post it because I wasn't quite sure what that meant. And she came back through and verified, and I posted this on the channel too. But she said death is required. So the Osirian energy was already, because we had Maat, we had Anubis, because we had the 11-11 portal. Then we kept having the portals back to back. And so she said, prepare for death. She said, my people, you are gods and goddesses now. You must stop gripping to the belief of death and fear that has been put in you, or you will fall victim. She said, you must learn to let things die. You got to let it die. Your diet, let it die. The pyramid, the food pyramid they gave you in school, let it die. You, to survive what's happening, you must let these things die. I was just blown away. And I haven't studied Egyptology or ancient Kemet or anything. This is just channel information coming through my meditations and from the astral realm. So it's good for you to verify that.
Exactly. Yeah. And it's verifiable, as I just stated. Everything is lining up and correlating to the fact of the Arsetian energy. September the 11th, the Virgin, the Virgo, that's astrologically right and exact. That's proven. Yeah. All right. Based on the calendar information. All right. And then Asaru, which is Betelgeuse, which is the constellation Orion. The word Orion means heaven. So when you hear people say, oh, God is in heaven, or the man upstairs, or the man up there, they talking about the constellation Orion.
That's right.
All right? And here it is, Betelgeuse, a portion of the constellation Orion, is coming to the planet Earth. It's here on the planet Earth, right here and right now.
Yeah.
That's no coincidence.
All right. Yeah, because what happened, I had a dream and I didn't know what it meant. A lot of stuff I post, I ask you guys because, you know, I know y'all are well-versed and well-studied. And so I dreamed that there was a planet, what appeared to be a planet that exploded. We could physically see it with our eyes. And when it exploded, the face that was on the planet was of a baby. But the baby looked very angry and evil. So I posted the dream and I was like, yo, why did I dream this? What's going on? Literally 24 hours after I posted that, somebody comments and was like, well, Lucifer is usually portrayed as this baby figure. And then I was like, okay, this is starting to make sense. And then that same day, the FRBs that come every 16 days from the star system was found, and they published that information. So I said, there we go, right there. Mm-hmm. NASA published it. That every 16 days, and they've been trying to gather people to interpret the encrypted FBR, which are the frequency radio signals coming through.
Right.
So that's to activate on the photon level. The EU melanin is, I mean, they're trying to stop it, but they can't.
Exactly. That's what their program was about. You know, this is what they was attempting to do when they did the Mandela effect.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
All right, and they changed some things around. This is what they was doing with the CERN. All right, trying to blast a hole into the atmosphere, a dimensional hole into the atmosphere. This is what they was working on. You know, everybody heard about these things, CERN and you know, and the Mandela effect and what is taking place. So they attempted to alter this from happening. Futile.
Mm-hmm.
That's true. Because Nelson Mandela was the first person, when you go to the Wayback Machine, that's who they began it with. And we were researching into that too. I was like, why is it so significant that Nelson Mandela had to be the one they named this after? And it was crazy because you remember at when he died the second time, because we both have memory of Nelson Mandela dying twice. And so my interpretation of that is even though they are altering the timeline for people who are accessing their multidimensional selves and practicing these practices to strengthen the pineal gland and the ability to transcend time and space, we remember it both ways. So I remember him dying in prison in the 80s, and I remember the funeral where the guy was doing the sign language, and they said the sign language didn't match what was supposed to be. You remember that?
Yeah.
They've been working hard on this one.
They was working hard on it now.
Oh, yeah, and I found the footage. I found the book that documents Nelson Mandela dying on the other timeline in the 80s, which is on our channel. And you can look at the author of the book, the date and everything. And then I found Billy Graham's funeral, because I remember his funeral. I found his funeral, went on live to show people the funeral of Billy Graham. And within 3 to 6 hours, they scrubbed it.
Wow.
And all of that's on our channel. Yeah, so we knew whatever was happening was major. They were needing to shift timelines the way that they were. But yeah, I mean, like you said, the omics already said, you know, right, this is 2012.
Right, if y'all can, post that into the chat, because people, I'm sure people will love to check that out, those two incidences.
Okay, yeah. When you go on the channel, go to the oldest videos first. Yeah, this one I realized, you know, coming through Hebrew Israelite, I had been not ever speaking and letting him lead everything in the studies at home. And so when this started coming through, I was like, I really don't understand what's going on here. I don't want to seem like I'm being disrespectful and not letting him be the teacher. But I was getting these downloads, and that's when I realized that I was the oracle. I didn't even know it was a name for it, you know. So, but when I found that footage, what happened was we started having a lot of incidents, issues with being on the live. So I started posting the links for people to go and find the residue of the old timeline the way we remember it used to be, you right. know. And so what YouTube started doing was they would process our videos, and they would be processing for 3 to 5 days
right.
to process a 30-minute video.
Yep.
And by the time the video was up, the links that I posted had been scrubbed. So, you know, but people who watched the video on the live were like, no, it was there because I went and checked it out.
Right.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
Type Mandela.
No, it didn't pull up.
Okay. In the name.
All right. So we are seeing what's really going on here. They're attempting to change timelines because they're trying to offset that September 11th, the real September 11th.
Mm-hmm.
All right? Which would be 2012, not the fake-ass 2012, December the 21st, 2012 that they told us about, which ain't shit happened.
Mm-hmm. Right.
All right? So we know what they was doing. They're trying to offset it. All right? So, no, that's what's going on.
Yep.
All right. I got some people in the chat that I want to shout out right quick. Brother Conscious One, peace, guy. You know what I'm saying? Always peace. Good to see you.
Peace.
What's good?
Good.
Yeah.
And Nalani, Peace, Goddess. Peace to the God. You know what I'm saying? Glad that y'all getting the chance to check out the live tonight. And for those that don't know, this is Brother Earnest and his divine mate, Khamsin. And they have their own channel. Goddess, tell them where your channel is located at and how they can kind of get in contact with y'all and watch the videos, you know, and everything.
Our information is definitely on YouTube. It's just under Cam's name, Khamsin. That's the channel. And then also you can go to our website, www.remnantsgathering.com.
All right. So, we're trying to bring y'all some information on which that will help tie a lot of the things that's going on. All right. Now, like I say, the goddess reached out to me. We've been knowing each other for a few years now. And she reached out back in February, actually January, when Kobe died. The day that Kobe died, she got a down. She got some downloads and reached out to me, which caused me to go and do some serious research into his brother's background, which I was able to give y'all the Kobe information. All right, and I mentioned the goddess name in that video. Now, I mentioned what happened with Kobe, but if you go back and listen, I mentioned Betelgeuse in that video.
Mm-hmm.
All right, I mentioned
Betelgeuse
in that video. So, you know, we didn't just start talking about Betelgeuse. We did this with Kobe, you know what I'm saying, months ago, you know, when we found out what was going on. All right. Mm-hmm. The energies that they was trying to stop from coming in, because Betelgeuse, from what we found out, is the doorman. All right, mm-hmm. I'll show you what I'm talking about. Let me see if I can pull up this joint here. All right, I'm going to share my screen again here, and y'all see what I'm talking about when we get into Betelgeuse. And because we got a lot of information to bring to you about Betelgeuse, the goddess has some serious downloads. The god got some spin on this information, which that's going to take y'all into a whole nother arena. So we're trying to give y'all some real pertinent information tonight. All right, so let me pull those up right quick.
Yeah,
We're going to create a playlist and put all of the videos mentioned in there, because Earnest is having a hard time sharing the images in the Zoom. So we'll create a playlist and then we'll make all of these videos available.
Oh, beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. Yeah. Sound like a plan, sound like a plan. All right, so I'm getting ready to share my screen. We're getting ready to go on in. All right. All right, so let's get to it. I guess I'll go into my rendition of what's taking place here. And then, you know, we can collate the information, y'all. All right. So we know that, as they say, Betelgeuse is about to go supernova. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? You know, y'all heard of Casanova, where it's getting ready to be just supernova. All right? Mm-hmm. Hey, so this is in Digital Journal, and it says Betelgeuse is about to go supernova, ? Well, we continue on. This is CNET.com. It says giant star Betelgeuse might explode soon, and the next few weeks are crucial.
Yeah.
Crucial. Why is it so crucial? Well, we continue on seeing, you know, what they're talking about. And we can see that Betelgeuse is about 700, or specifically 642.5 light years away. For that energy to reach us at the speed of light, it would take basically means that it would have blown up about 642 or 700 years ago, approximately. And this is ancient information bombarding us right now. This is by my good friend, Michael Bell. He stated that. Now, this correlates perfectly, as we stated, with the movie Beetlejuice. Now, was a movie that Tim Burton put out back in 1988. All right, Tim Burton is a director, but he's also was an actor. All right. And the plot revolves around a recently deceased couple. Mm-hmm. This is why you see these brothers that have passed on. They have been deceased or became living relatives or the living ancestors, not no longer dead relatives, but living ancestors.
Mm-hmm.
You have a devious poltergeist named Beetlegeuse, all right, who was played by who? Michael Keaton. And he was from the Netherworld. So Beetlegeuse is the Netherworld. Well, hold on. Where did Asaru go to? Asaru went into what? The Netherworld, the Underworld.
Right.
All right. And so this is showing us the science once again. And it shows you even in the movie that Beetlejuice's name actually was Beetlegeuse. And there was a sign right there in Las Vegas by that Tim Burton put in there. And it's pointed towards Beetlegeuse. Beetlegeuse. Now, notice that it said Beetlegeuse twice, but it didn't say the third time.
Third time, yeah.
Oh, all right. So we'll get to that. All right, so. All right. So we go further on here. Let me get on down. All right, so as we find out, a lot of things is taking place, and Beetlegeuse actually stands for the doorman of the underworld, the Netherworld. So what does a doorman do? The doorman lets you in, right?
Mm-hmm.
A doorman lets you in. Mm-hmm. Now, the person who's against the doorman is Bill Gates.
Mm-hmm.
Now, what does a gate do? A gate is to keep you out.
Yeah.
That's right.
Yeah.
Uh-oh, now we see the correlation.
Mm-hmm. Uh-huh.
Now we see the correlation. So here we have Bill Gates, all right, and he's talking about you can't travel without a vaccine certificate.
Yeah.
All right. Eventually, we will have to have is a certificate of who's a recovered person and who's a vaccinated person, because you don't want people moving around the world without their certificate.
Right. Mm-hmm. Without their chip.
So he is to attempt to keep us out. All right?
Mm.
This is the thing. Vaccines against population. The meeting was convened on the initiative of the man deemed by Forbes to be the world's richest. Mm. The founder of Microsoft. Warren Buffett ranks second on Forbes, who has pledged $31 billion to the bulk of his future to Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation and David Rockefeller. Mm. Find out that Bill Gates is a Rockefeller.
Mm.
He is right. Part of the family.
Mm-hmm.
That's right.
All right, he is part of the family. Who Bill Gates really is? Well, Bill Gates' father, William Henry Gates, was an attorney and sat on the board of Planned Parenthood. His mother, Mary Maxine, was a successful businesswoman. Maxwell's grandfather was James Willard Maxwell, who was a wealthy banker. Bill Gates' ninth great-grandfather was Stephen Gifford, who had two children, Hannah Gifford and Samuel Gifford. Hannah line leads 10 generations down to Bill Gates. Samuel line leads 7 generations down to none other than Nelson Rockefeller, the 41st vice president of the United States. Boom, family. Gates, Rockefellers, same damn family. Same family. All right, so here Gates is doing what? He could damn, look, could dimming the sun save the earth? Or could it trigger calamity? So what is he trying to do? He hired two professors, two scientists, to begin experiment to block out the sun. Mm-hmm. This is what Bill Gates did.
Mm-hmm.
All right, now, chemtrails obviously was not working fast enough for him.
Mm-hmm.
Before, during, and after you get the chemtrails, obviously it wasn't working fast enough for him. All right? They've been spraying chemtrails on us for damn near 25 years.
Since
95, you know what I'm saying? Some say it wasn't until 97. Regardless, damn near 25 years.
That's a long-ass time. Exactly. That's a
long-ass time for them to be spraying our asses.
Right.
Like we got damn roaches and shit. But yeah. hey, as my man said, we baby kids. We don't die.
Oh, yeah.
All right.
Look,
the underworld, our world anyway, so.
Robin Harris, he told us that. All right,
yep. Right.
Science. All right, so we baby kids. We don't die, we multiply.
Yeah.
All right, so right here, what we find out is that this man is behind this shit. He is trying to stop the rays of the sun from coming in because we have a problem. There's a serious situation going on with them. And I'll show you what I'm talking about. All right, there's a serious situation going on with them. So here we have, all right, Bill Gates' serious problem. What is that serious problem? Let's go up right quick and check that serious problem out. All right, so what's the serious problem? Well, this is the serious problem. Fewer births than deaths among whites in majority of United States.
Mm-hmm.
Hold on, what does this mean? This means that there's 29 states, more than 29 states, that reports that there are more whites dying than reproducing.
Yep.
That's more than half of the states. We're talking about 30 states. There's only 50. And right. 30 states, they are dying. And the Census Bureau has projected that whites could drop below 50% of the population around 2045.
Mm-hmm.
This is why they're working so hard.
Yep. And it's interesting that you say that because 2045 is the year that they're going to implement the immortal man with the AI transferring the consciousness to live for eternity.
Right.
Exactly.
2045.com is the website, actually.
Yeah, we did.
And they have what is called the soul snatcher chip, in which
you put
the chip inside your brain in order to download all your experiences, and then a robotic android body sleeve, as they refer to it as, because you can see carbon dated, the TV series that they can go from body to body with the same consciousness. They can go from body to body with the same consciousness on that damn soul chip.
Yeah, and because of the chemtrail and getting a lot of people that are claiming that they have more gelatin, and there's like fiber like shit that's just, you know what I'm saying, forming in our bodies.
Exactly. Exactly.
And one more thing to add with the you're talking about the inability for them to have children at the same rate melanated people, and we're talking about this. I realized that with the black matter, the dark matter, we had the dark ooze all over the earth, all of these things happening. It, to me, it was a manifestation of dark matter coming back to reign as it was supposed to, because darkness has been depicted as black and evil. And so I perceived it as this returning of the ancient, the return of the ancient ones, exactly, which we know were depicted as black. And so what's happening is they're trying to, the reason why Queen Elizabeth allowed her son to marry a black woman was to bring that EU melanin into the bloodline so that their generations would be preserved with the new photons.
Exactly. That's exactly what's going on. And how we know that to be true, because we've done had Masonic Shriners in the age of 70 to almost 80 years old to approach us and tell us specifically that the only way that they're going to survive is if they mix it.
That's right.
This is what we told. Go ahead, brother Earnest.
I was gonna say you mentioned how Bill Gates and he got a lot of funding from other folks, and how he have been working, especially with the vaccines, but then trying to block out the sun rays. And going back to Beetlejuice, going back to the movie. Did you know it's a part in the movie where when the new family moved in, well, I guess this is the wife and the brother or whoever the guy, funny acting guy was, they went around the house spraying. Did you notice the colors and what they were doing? They sprayed purple and a mauve color. And we found out that he actually stated to use teal green or hydrochromic oxide. This is what he told the wife.
Right.
And that derives from electrochromism.
Right.
And it's the phenomenon where the color or opacity of a material changes when a voltage is applied. By doing so, an electrochromic smart window can block ultraviolet, visible, or near infrared light instantaneously and on demand.
Read that.
The ability to control transmittance of near infrared light can increase the energy efficiency of a building, reducing the amount of energy needed to cool during the summer and heat during the winter.
Sounds like the mechanisms of melanin to me.
Yep. That's exactly what that is.
They try to create their own. But wasn't that interesting that they put that in Beetlejuice? That's really stood out to me, that he sprayed a mauve X on the wall. Yeah. And that was the very first wall he wanted to deal with. And so I studied the periodic elements. And so as soon as I heard him say that, I said, wait a minute, that's something that's going to block UV, ultraviolet, photons, and even some radio frequencies. Mm-hmm. And so they're getting this put in all of their windows and their homes, their vehicles to protect them. But with that being said, blue blockers. But I'm gonna tell you what's the crazy connection is that this just further validates what you're saying as to how old this particular agenda is. Because right after Prince died, and he's known for Purple Rain, so we're talking about the mauve and the color purple and the crown chakra, which is related to corona, the auric field around the body. Okay, and so with all of that being said, the connection is the queen, 2 days after Prince died, she had wore purple, and they had this big ceremony where purple was the main color. And I got all the screenshots and pictures because it caught my attention, and I knew that they were beginning with Prince. So what they did with Kobe was a continuation of a ritual that had already began.
Right. Exactly. And see, Black Dot, in his book, The Five Elements of Hip Hop, he breaks down that Kobe was no longer needed because they got their new nigga, which was King James or LeBron James.
Good old King James. They found a way to make the Bible back relevant to the people who didn't got free from the lower understanding of it.
That's crazy. Yeah.
Yeah, that kind of upset me. I did ask Kobe about that, and he said to me, I was already prepared for this, which is why I was calling myself Black Mamba, which is why I studied with the Zen masters, which is why I got into dark alchemy, dark magic, and began teaching it in the form of children's books, the same way Walt Disney was doing, I took it back. I took back what they were doing with the Old Testament, and I was making it right. He said, so tell my people, stop grieving and crying. I am in a position to help. I am returning to Orion's belt. This was before I made the Betelgeuse connection and knowing that it was part of Orion's belt. So when that information came through you, I told Earnest, I was like, oh, shit. I can't even fake it no more. Like, this is accurate. If Dr. Bay pointed out, that shit, that's Bible.
Yeah, it correlates. It all correlates.
Yeah, it does. And when as far as the battle that Kobe was going through with that pharmaceutical company, High-Tech, right. All about Black Mamba. All about using Black Mamba. He exposed the fact that they had been for some type of dietary pills that they were producing, that they had been using some banned
substances.
That's and right.
So that was the whole court issue that he was battling with them about.
That's right.
Khamsin, and one other thing, God is color, God is when they put him on LA Lakers, that was part of the ritual too. That's why they made such a big deal about that. They was planning it then.
God is go back to what you just said about Kobe said that he was coming from the Orion constellation.
Yeah, he told me. Like I said, I'm getting comfortable with being public about this, so bear with me.
It's all right.
But he told me that he was returning to Orion's belt, and that he would give me confirmation that I would be able to share with the people. Because I told him I don't want to look crazy, and I don't want to put information out that's inaccurate. And
that's right.
What's crazy, Brother Panic was the one that connected the dots for me. Because he was talking about the passing of Gerald Levert and how he was also one, him and his three brothers, his father, one of the parts of the Orion's belt, one of the sons was returning. And he was saying to tap into that energy. This was about 8 to 12 months before this took place. So the way Kobe translated it to me was that's where they were returning to for the specific purpose. And if you remember, Gerald Levert's number one song was Casanova, which connects to the supernova.
Exactly. That's exactly what I was saying. That exactly. But there it is.
Yep.
Whoop! There it is.
There it is. Hey, y'all. Yeah. Hey, that's old school, y'all. Y'all know nothing about that. All right.
Yeah.
All right. So. Here's another article called Brown Watch, and this is an article by the United Nations World Population Study shows the declining white race is less than 10%. Less than 10% of the world's 7.7 billion population. Motivating racism to act genocidally in a perceived survival game with non-whites. So let's read this right quick.
Mm-hmm.
So this is powerful. It says that the 2019 revision of the world population prospects is the 26th edition of United Nations Population Estimates and Projections. It says, whither goest thou, white man? But it says, yeah. Population estimates from 1950 to the present, 235 countries.
Wow.
Underpinned by analysis of historical demographic trends is the latest estimate concerning the results of 1,690 national population census conducted between 1950 to 2018.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And it says, as well as information from vital registration systems and from 2,700 national representative sample surveys. 2019 revision also presented population projections to the year 2100. What happened? And the possible outcome of the global, regional, and county level. Okay, well let's see what happens. Let's see what happens. Lord have mercy. The population estimates and projection provided in the World Population Perspective divided two of the four demographic megatrends, population growth and aging, as well as key trends in human fertility, mortality, and net international migrations that are integral to sustainable development. Collectively, these data constitute a crucial part of the evidence base for monitoring global progress towards the achievement of the sustainable development goal of by 2030. All right. What is it that they're trying to do? All right. Well, World Population Projective 2019 confirmed the world population continue to grow, albeit at a slow rate. Point to the challenges facing some countries and regions. Note the population size is decreasing in some countries due to sustained low fertility and immigration. Underscore the opportunities available in the countries. Highlight the unprecedented aging of the world population. The ongoing global increases in longevity. Describe how international migration becomes an important determinant of population growth. And all of that is to say this, that according to the Caucasian, the incredible shrinking race, fiend with a face. This is what Chuck D said, Public Enemy. He said the incredible shrinking race, fiend with a face. Complex with the good old boys, Yorugu network connection. Not the G-O-B-Y-N, all right? G-Y-N, but G-O-B-Y-N. The good old boy, Yorugu network. One who worst and most basic fear shall remain genetic annihilation in the form of fear of the impending black planet. Wow. Whether they're gold-style white man, and it says, Yorugu, Western civilization, recessive genes, colored people, melanin, and mutants. This is by Wittekiko, disease. All right, you can see that. And it says this is an article in the ISIS papers by Dr. Francis Quest Welzin. Most white people consciously or subconsciously understand the following. White plus black equals colored. White plus brown equal colored. White plus yellow equal colored. Although rarely discussed, white people are genetically recessive. It is scientific facts that blacks are genetically dominant traits. Whatever black mixes with white, which is a recessive genetic trait, black will dominate. And in general, it means whites cannot reproduce a white child when they have sexual relations with non-whites. The so-called white race can and eventually can be replaced or genetically annihilated through simulations or social intermixing with white people, non-whites. The declining white population is not a new or reversible trend. It's not reversible. The trend has only quickened. So you see, this is why they had to hurry up and do what they're trying to do now.
Right.
You know what's amazing? AI
technology. Because the AI technology is the only way they're going to survive. This is what
exactly. Yep. Is there's no other way. And I know some people might agree with this, but when I meditate, my intention, and I've said, is to time travel and gather information throughout the timeline of black history. And so back when they were training black men to be young bucks and sending them to different plantations to have these children, that at the time it was working against us, but it was a setup for us, because now through epigenetics, a lot of black men have been pre-programmed, and so they have children from state to state to state. Look at the rappers and how many children they got. And so the very thing that they was trying to use to stop us actually helped us in the future. So I'm not saying it's okay to run off and leave your children, but I want people to see the higher perspective of the shit that this man does to destroy us is being used to build us up.
Yep. Exactly. Cause we baby kids.
Yeah.
Like that's it's no coincidence. My last name is Bay.
There you go.
Yeah.
And so here it is. A recent rector from poll reflects white people's fear of replacement, as 31% of the participants agree. America must protect and preserve its white European heritage. Mm. And 39% agrees with the statement that white people are currently under attack in this country.
Mm. You think?
Yeah, you think? So, it's the fear of replacement and or fear of losing control over non-whites that fueled the system of white supremacy racism. I don't call it per se white supremacy, I call it inferiority complex.
That's right. Mm-hmm.
Yep.
That's right. Dr. Judy did an excellent job explaining post-traumatic slave syndrome. And even talking about the religious organizations and how they were created. You know, I just hope our people, I hope this information helps our people to awaken from the spell that they have been placed under to stop them from ascending. Because as long as we left Hebrew Israelite, because there were questions that were not getting answered, and right. We were having to go to metaphysics to get the answers, and you were one of the implemental people, and Brother Panic, and Phil Valentine, and Delva Blair, and Bobby Hemmett. And so what ended up happening was, when we left the whole Hebrew Israelite movement, it was a big deal.
Christianity.
Yeah, right.
Yeah.
We left Christianity, then we became Hebrew Israelites, and then we came out of that. And the main thing that what caused us to awaken was seeing how this interracial thing was being pushed in all the commercials, the movie, right. The mountain between us, with yeah. What's the black guy name that's got coronavirus, Idris Elba, the mountain between us. That movie triggered us so bad that we had to do a decoded on the movie to explain how they were activating fear. And so when they started shooting black men and hanging Sandra Bland, at that point it's undeniable of the inferiority that they feel.
Right. Indeed. That's exactly what's going on. Mm-hmm. So, we continue on, and it says this. And causes racists to act genocidal towards non-whites in a perceived survival game. They are engaged in with non-whites. Racists believe that the only way they can survive or not and not be replaced is by dominating non-white persons.
Mm.
As the world's true minority, the only way white people could rule the world was by implementing a genocidal global program of deception, destruction, and domination.
Mm-hmm.
This is what they're doing right now.
Right.
AKA a war for genetic survival against non-whites.
Mm-hmm.
To racism, mm-hmm. A failure to create such a system would lead to the disappearance of the white race. This is why they're so fucking desperate.
Yep.
As stated by Welson, if white people has not created such a global system in which they establish power over the world's non-white majority, the white collective would have been genetically extinct a long time ago.
Mm-hmm.
So they own borrowed time.
Mm-hmm.
And by 2045, as we already said, they're gonna have to develop robotic sleeves. The only way to do that is to have this shit above 5G level.
That's right.
This is why they're willing to kill every goddamn thing on the planet to damn get to the 5G. Fuck the birds falling out the sky. Fuck the, fuck the trees can't bear leaves and fruit. They don't care.
Mm-hmm.
As long as they damn get their sleeves and they can survive.
Mm-hmm.
Form after this.
It's futile because the missing element, so many of us have awakened to simple things like fluoride and changing our diet and using sea moss and bladderwrack and chlorella and spirulina. It's futile because we are coming to the understanding. I did a meditation with Arcturian energy, and the Arcturians told me that they are transitioning us to the higher dimensions where healing will be done by light and sound frequency only.
Exactly. And that's why I teach that right now.
Yeah,
exactly.
So see, this is what I'm talking about. This is where we have to move into. This is the fifth dimension. That's why I made mention of the fact, hold on, let's go back and listen to the fifth dimension and the song Age of Aquarius and the let the sun shine in.
Yes.
Yep.
Earth, right. Wind, and Fire kept telling us we were stars.
Yep. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Shining stars so you can see. Those two songs.
Yep.
Those two songs we need to be playing every day.
Light pole activations.
That's it.
Right.
That's light pole
activation.
That's right.
And as we playing it, Beetlegeese.
All day.
Yep.
All right. So this is what we're gonna be doing. So right here, it says Wesson's color confrontation theory explains that the more the white population shrinks, the worse its conduct towards non-white people will get.
Mm-hmm.
Racism, this is what we've seen with them killing the people, our people, over the last 5-6 years, more. This is what we've seen.
Yeah. Racism. I mean, it turned up to the point where we started teaching our son, we started teaching him a script in case he ever has a confrontation with police officers.
Exactly.
That needs to be the Ten Commandments. We need the Ten Commandments to teach our sons and our daughters how to respond in those situations, because this is real.
Yeah, this is real.
This is real. And and one other thing I'm going to add quickly is that I asked myself this question recently. I said, okay, if 5D healing would be done through light and through sound frequency, well, it makes sense the reason why with the music, there is no other race who call their women hoes and sluts and ain't good for nothing but the nut in their face. And like country music don't do it. East Indians don't do it. Hispanics don't do it. Nobody do they women how they do, but then we know that the industry is ran by the cabal, and so they're using sound frequency as a weapon against us on top of the 5G, the wind towers, and the chemtrails.
So they disrespect the woman, but didn't want to be her at the same time.
At the same time, worshiping our womb, Islam, walking around the black box in the Catholic Church, bowing to the black Madonna. They know what it really is.
Yep.
And Kanika, if y'all remember Kanika, she came to me about 3 or 4 days ago.
Mm.
And she said, I want to tell you why they took me and took my organs.
Right.
She said the plan didn't go the way it was supposed to. They had been using these hotel parties to take these young black girls out of Chicago.
Yep.
And she said to me, I said, "What? Hold on, let me find a note, because I put it in the email that I sent you, because this blew me away." She specifically said to me that all of the young black girls, that if you realize how many young black girls went missing leading up to the coronavirus, she said what they were doing was getting a stock on the organs of young black girls and doing experiments to access so that they can use the EU melanin to try to protect them. And if I'm not mistaken, melanin is about $330 plus per gram, according to the melanin theft documentary on the market.
Yeah.
And she specifically said to me, go and look up the meaning of my name and I'll prove to you what I'm saying. I went and looked up the definition of Kanika. And Kanika, first of all, it's a very rare name. And from Nigeria, because you mentioned Nigeria, she says the name Kanika, it means Ki-ni-ka, which is mother's own, is great or big. It also derived from Igbo name Nika, which means mother is greater or bigger, and is of Nigerian origin. Now, I wanted to see if you could chime in on something on that, because obviously that was a connection.
Well.
Oh, and also that Kanika is an anagram of Nek. And Nek is this reptilian frog-looking AI that they use with Anon to decode events, a lot of the computer hackers and programmers and stuff. If you look up Nek, you will see the image of this frog. However, according to Hebrew and the Bible, sacrifice as a sin offering or burnt offering had their heads wrung or pinched off from their necks. This is according to Leviticus 5 and 8 and 1 Samuel 4 and 18. The Hebrew word mefreketh signifies a fracture of the upper part of the spinal column caused by a fall. Now that's significant because in the movie Beetlejuice, on the cover, you see a cutting off of the head at the neck. Mm-hmm. Also the spinal column, which represents Jacob's ladder, which represents the ascension and the raising of the kundalini, is cutting off that serpent kundalini energy from rising in the community, which is the same thing as Black Mamba rising. So now Nika in Igbo means her mother is renowned. Who is the mother of humanity? The Black woman.
Exactly.
Yep.
And what is coming September the 11th? The Osirian energy.
Yeah.
The mother principle.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Finally, that's the kundalini.
Absolutely.
So that means the Osirian energy will meet the Osirian energy. So that's Christ consciousness.
Yeah.
Mary consciousness, Mary Magdalene consciousness.
Yeah.
And the two will merge to form Heru, or as this case is, the rebirth consciousness. They call it Heru consciousness, Buddha consciousness. They call it Christ consciousness. You know, all of these are talking about the same thing, but it's talking about once the kundalini energy rises to the pineal gland and awaken the divine soul principle within each and every one of us, and it becomes awakened. That is the key. All right, that's what's going on. All right.
That's very key. And Cody had a chapter in the book. As I read through the book, I'm going to probably end up doing some videos and sharing it with y'all because the books are becoming hard to get. So I would say if you want to get them and save them, I think we should honor what he was trying to do for our people.
We have all the books. My wife ordered all the books after you you told her.
Okay, awesome. Because that's going to be
all the books.
That's the new script for Black people in the 5D and upper dimensions. That's going to be the new script in which we'll live by in the form of metaphysics. And I want to give him one more thing on Kanika. Go ahead.
Okay, and see, we'll be able to take that Mamba mentality further. You know what I'm saying? It's not just about basketball. You know what I'm saying? Everybody equate that to you know, about his drive as an athlete and one of the greatest basketball players.
Come on over here, what's going on with you.
It's definitely more light into the type of lifestyle that we should be living.
That's right. And I want to share. Hey, Goddess.
Peace.
In the books, here.
Yeah.
You have a queen.
How you doing, queen?
I can't complain. Busy as all get out trying to get these orders out.
The Wizenard series.
Yep. Yes.
Ipanka, the Tree of Force, or Force.
Yeah. Yeah.
F-Crop.
Yeah.
Yes.
All right. Woo!
You got it.
He has another one, which is
called. Look, He took the whole mythology of the Titans and rewrote it.
Yep.
Oh, that's what this is?
Phenomenal.
This is the Island of the Gods. And then he has another one, which is a red one.
Yes. Yeah.
Which we also have. So, you know, we have the books.
Yeah.
Us too.
And they're also for sale because we got multiple copies because we ain't
paying. Yeah. Absolutely. That's right. I want to share one more thing, too, with the missing Black girls. The reason why Kanika was the first one that went missing, when I went back to look up the a more relation to her name with a slightly different spelling, it's spelled K-A-N-I-K-A. Check this out. It generally means atom, A-T-O-M, or molecule, or seed. And it is of Indian Egyptian origin. The name Kanika is a feminine name. Persons with name Kanika are mainly Hindu by religion. However, the name originated from Egypt. And it also says that the name also means dark cloth and black. Wow. So this is a whole molecular restructuring with dark matter, divine primordial feminine energy, and which is wife, why it was so important for his daughter dying with him.
Yeah, and my wife studied that Kanika Jenkins case for a long time. She studied that like crazy, and she also studied the Kobe Bryant thing like crazy. So, you know, as soon as y'all built on it, she that morning went in and bought every book she could find.
Yep, absolutely.
And she been telling everybody, who comes in into the restaurant and the store, you need Kobe Bryant books.
That's right.
Yeah, he was very deep. Yeah. One thing that was crazy though, we connected some dots as it related to the Beetlejuice movie and Beetlegeese. The fact that Beetlejuice was called a bio exorcist. Mm-hmm. Did you catch that?
Yeah.
In the movie, Beetlejuice was calling himself a bio exorcist.
Right.
Now, Beetlegeese has that energy and that power behind it to where it's just wiping out everything that ain't in order.
Right.
The word, and so,
come to find out, he's Marshall. As in martial law, as in Mars, the same type of warrior energy.
Yeah. You know,
that would be our Michael who does battle against the devil, Satan.
That's right.
You know what I'm saying? Coming with the
sword. That's right.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
And another interesting thing with Beetlegeese, this was when I was channeling the points for the show. They specifically said, okay, y'all tap into Beetlegeese and the planet and what it's going to do for you, but I need you all to remember the scarab is the symbol of immortality, resurrection, transformation, and protection, and it is much used in funerary art. The life of the scarab beetle revolved around the dung balls that the beetles consumed, laid their eggs in. This is related to fertility of our people, and fed their young, representing a cycle of rebirth.
Yo.
Now, when I went to look up geese by itself, this also connected to ancient Egypt, which just blew me away.
Right.
The written histories of ancient Egypt and Mesopotamia, because geese means beer.
Right.
And so ancient Egypt and Mesopotamia recorded the first brewing and distribution of beer. And in the Epic of Gilgamesh describes beer's role in the transformation of primitive man to civilized man.
Mm.
So the reason why most white people own the companies, they reverse engineer our technology of beer to have the opposite effect. So now they are turning melanated people and putting them in a primitive frequency, which is why malt liquor is heavily sold on every corner in any hood. And you look at the crime in those areas where it is being sold, that was reverse engineering.
Wow.
Yeah.
Great point, Queen.
Yeah, excellent point.
And one other thing that stood out, and I could run through this because I study it like night and day. We didn't sleep last night. That's why we needed a nap before the show. So Beetlejuice, geese, is also a part of Orion, which is connected to Egypt, ancient Kemet, which is connected to beer, which is connected to Corona, which is connected to the coronavirus, which is connected to Kobe. Kobe name in Hebrew, it means corona. So we know that Kemet is Africa. So this was his lineage as well. This also connects to the pyramids, which connect to Orion's belt, which connects to Nefertiti, which was recently an excavation site during this coronavirus. And from what I understood, the ancestors told me that a curse and a virus was released during the excavation of Nefertiti's site. So they thought they were doing more harm, but they were doing more danger to themselves. And this virus hadn't even been spoken about or discovered yet, but it will be confirmed this year. They also led me to more research into geese in ancient Egypt being the creators of beer, and the word black market kept showing up. And it said black market for high potency distilled alcohol and high cost of enforcing the law and a sharp increase in crime rates. This was the article about geese. It says to desire to create jobs during the Great Depression of the 1930s also encouraged the repeal of prohibition. Many people continued to brew and distribute beer or geese and other alcoholic beverages during the prohibition, but all this economic activity was happening on a black market basis. Now, what made that stand out to me was that the word Great Depression kept coming up. We have went back into a repression of the economy, the second Great Depression. Black market connected it back to the black market of our organs and our melanin. And then it also connected back to Africa. And there's no way I could make these connections, so I can't take credit. But in 2002, and we can provide the links to this if you all want to research it for yourselves. In 2002, the large African beer maker, South African Breweries, SAB, bought Miller Brewing Company, which was the second largest U.S. beer maker and a longtime industry leader. The early 2000s marked another change in the global beer landscape as, get this, China surpassed the United States as the country with the highest total of beer consumption. Mm. Neither country ranks in the top 10 on a per capita basis, but the United States had long been the leader in the total consumption. Key words here, Africa and China.
Yeah.
And so what happens is the yeast, the hops and the grains and the GMO materials in the beer, because China was the top consumer, this is also the second reason that coronavirus broke out like it did in China, because they are the highest beer consumers. So this is also why we see the image of Kobe drinking a Corona. They also buried him at Corona Dale. His burial site was named Corona as well. Corona del Mar, which is Spanish for crown of the sea.
Right.
And so crown of the sea, as in crown chakra, and sea, which is the primordial life form from which we all originated, mother or matter, which goes back to Kanika being the mother of renown. And it says that light is the catalyst on land and in the oceans. This goes back to all of the supplements you mentioned. It says, if life comes from the oceans, then rebirth or baptism is done with water. So this is why we are being dehydrated. We are being reborn as a result of the warfare or a baptism, but by fire, not by water. And that's in the Bible, and the fire is Betelgeuse.
Exactly. Woo.
It says, to destroy by water will not be how the world ends. It's by fire, according to the Bible. So the explosion of Betelgeuse is the spark of fire needed to activate the junk DNA into our crystalline structure light body. So Kobe and Kanye were both being used for this mass ritual to try to stop the awakening or the rebirth. And the reason I threw Kanye in there is because Kanye started calling himself the son of God and right, doing all this Jesus talk and traveling with this Sunday service stuff. This was right, all connected. That was really the Horus energy, but it was translating itself in the form of Jesus through Kanye. Yeah. So there was a connection. And then that's when I sent the song to you with the lyrics between Kanye and Katy Perry about the extraterrestrials and the activation of star seeds.
Right, and Kanye means king.
Exactly. Yeah. Exactly. And the Kanye used the code AR I think was AR2772. He had it on his shirt when he did the interview with Big Boy. Mm-hmm. I went and looked that up, and that took me to the sunspot that they had just discovered on the sun that were having these major mass corona explosions. Mm-hmm. And that all just connected the whole thing. And when I looked up AR2272, I went into the ley lines and the longitude, latitude, and it led me to Jerusalem, Arkansas. And you can decode yourself why Jerusalem was through in that mix. And you can just see the architecture of this whole strategy on a physical and spiritual level with these connections.
Jerusalem, yeah. See, that's what we're talking about, y'all.
Yeah.
Y'all getting it tonight, damn it. Y'all getting the metaphysical decoding of this tonight.
Telling you.
All right. So, as stated by Francis Questwell, the war for white genetic survival is conducted simultaneously on 9 battlefronts. Economics. This is why they're bringing the economy down.
Yeah.
Can't go to work.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? They got to give you $1,200 to $2,400 based on your circumstances.
You mm-hmm. see the number 12 too, with it being 2012.
Right.
Well, yep. You know what I'm saying?
Where they get that number from?
Exactly. Where they get that number from?
They just put it at
So they talking about economy. The economy is going to shit. Put.
Yep.
Wall Street has reached a record low. It's in recession. We're actually worse than we were in 2008.
Yep.
Businesses are closed. AMC, which is the movie theater, has filed for bankruptcy.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Okay. All of these things are taking place.
Yes.
Education. Children is no longer having to go to school. They will be homeschooled. We have to be online.
Yeah, we're gonna talk about that. That's a reset.
Mm-hmm. Right. The schools, when they do open back up, you know what I'm saying? Most of them will be closed. The ones that do open back up will have 5G capabilities, and this is what they wanted the children out of the school so they can put in the 5G capabilities.
That's all true.
And someone that worked for, can't remember the name of the company, but I discovered someone that worked for the company, they kind of became a whistleblower because they have children, school age children, they felt bad about it. And so they released documents, they released the maps of which schools he had been working on with that particular company. And he was saying that, so what happened, a couple went to the school to see what was going on. There was these unmarked white vans there. Installing 5G.
Yep.
So absolutely. And this is why it's so important that we get our children on chlorella and spirulina and bladderwreck and sea moss to protect them if they have to go back. But hopefully some of us will have the confidence to be able to homeschool our children after this.
Right.
Exactly. Yeah.
Exactly. Hopefully.
Yeah.
Hopefully.
Yeah.
Right. Hopefully.
But if we can't do anything else, we can at least continue to press the information that Dr. Sabi and Dr. Africa and the likes thereof, you know, they died trying to help us with this upcoming battle, you know.
Exactly.
And I feel like that's the least that we can do to honor them. So, you know, our kids, we've been putting them on smoothies. If we got to sneak it in a smoothie and fill it up with a whole bunch of fruit so they can't taste it, you just got to do what you got to do to protect them.
Exactly.
Which is why the metaphysics of Kobe was so important, because I went and found an interview and he specifically said that he was doing this for children who grew up in poverty and in the hood and without both parents, because he said that the goal in them being successful is learning how to transmute the darkness, practice dark magic and alchemy.
Yep.
His words exactly.
Yep. Yeah, he said that. Mm-hmm. And of course they took that down.
Oh yeah.
Yep. So did. As soon as I found the screenshot and posted it, put the link. Everybody was like, yo, it ain't even there no more, guys.
Nope. Not there.
It's crazy.
They took it down. You know, but I mean, this is what they do, you know, and it's all because of, you know, what is taking place.
Yeah, but now it can't be stopped. They can't not stop us from getting the knowledge.
No.
Mm-hmm. And with the help that we have now, with the higher dimensions, I mean, looking at the people who have transitioned, and you mentioned that at the top of the show, I mean, we have a whole army that we didn't have a month ago.
That's right.
You know,
yeah.
And I feel like, which is why it's so important for us to, because if you remember High Tech, the company that was trying to use Black Mamba, those are the makers of Sipping on Scissor.
Right.
High Tech is the main manufacturer of that drug that we know has been impacting our community in a terrible way. And it's no coincidence that drug is purple. They work with colors and the frequencies of colors and the numbers and the numerology and Enochian magic with the letters and these names, just as you mentioned. And so, you know, it's just awakening to being able to receive the truth. So we had, what's his name, Pimp C. They said he died of an overdose of this same high-tech promethazine syrup. Yeah. And then a lot of other people recently, mm-hmm. Juice WRLD, they said he died of an overdose. So even the youngins, you know. So what I feel is happening, whatever the substances are that's in the diet pills, I couldn't find a list of those substances.
That's it right there, Black Mama.
Mm-hmm. Yep. And for so many Black women who deal with obesity, I think it's really important to pay attention to the things that Dr. Bay have been telling you guys, because there is a natural way to do everything. And I believe that these pills under the name Black Mama for losing weight are probably going to be marketed to Black women, and just channeling what I feel intuitively, it would be to cause sterilization.
Now, to each his own, if you like beer, it is what it is. But what we found that one of the most fucked up, the most damaging ingredients in beer is a synthetic material called, how you pronounce that? Propylene glycol.
Mm-hmm.
You familiar with that one?
Yes.
And it says that propylene glycol increases your skin's propensity to absorb whatever comes into contact with. Considering the large amounts of dangerous chemicals we encounter on a regular basis, this may even be more dangerous than the compound itself.
Right.
And so if propylene glycol is the main component of beer, and again, we're talking about beer because of Betelgeuse, geese is beer, and yep. coronavirus, the beer corona, yep. if anybody missed out. But that's important because anything that increases the skin absorption, which is the main organ, that means that the chemtrails, the heavy metals that they're spraying on us, are going to have a bigger impact. Yeah. And so when they hit us with the 5G, because you're drinking beer already, the absorption from that particular chemical is amplified. Yep. So this is the secret in how they're trying to penetrate the protection of the melanin with these specific chemicals in beer. And they know most Black people love their beer. Yep. We right. put it on our ancestor altar because my grandma's beer. Mm-hmm. But you can just see who the target is
yep.
in this situation. Yep. But we're not the highest rate of deaths, which means I hope some people see that this means that ancestor protection is so important, because if it wasn't for them, because this attack was directed at us, we would have been some of the highest level race of people being impacted by the coronavirus. But what they're finding is that when I did a remote viewing, there's something that the coronavirus activates within the blood of people with EU melanin. And so it causes it to turn into a more recessive form. And so this is why the Black people who have gotten it, Idris Elba, a lot of the basketball players, was it Charles Barkley? Who?
Yeah, yeah.
Okay. Yeah. They're not going to die from it. And so hopefully this will get people to have more, to believe more. To know in the age of Aquarius, it's about knowing, and not the Pisces about believing. So to know yep. that there is something special about you being melanated.
Right.
Absolutely.
Guys, you want to go more into the BETELGEUSE information?
Yeah, we got a little bit more. I think probably we should push this
all right
on out.
Yeah.
I don't know. I think I did hear you talk about this in your lecture with Brother Patty. In your lecture with Brother Patty, if I'm not mistaken, you all mentioned this.
I want to watch this movie. I really need to. I just wrote about the.
Every
16
days.
Oh, yeah, somebody unmuted their phone, so.
Okay.
Yeah.
So with this particular message, this signal, this radio frequency signal that they're getting from this other galaxy, is every 16.35 days. The significance of this is the pattern. So for 4 days, it spits out a burst every 2 hours. Then for 12 days, it falls silent. And then it repeats itself. That's important. That's the 12 connection again, right, with this being 2012.
Right, every 12 days, yeah.
And it's silent for 12 days. This radio frequency signal goes completely silent for 12 days. If this doesn't prove intelligence, I don't know what does. But what stood out about this, because a lot of people are about to be activated, but let me give a little bit of the science on how these particular fast radio bursts impact us. So according to the astronomer with the Canadian Hydrogen Intensity Mapping Experiment, collaboration in Canada observed this cycle for a total of 409 days. It says, we don't know yet what it means, but it could be another piece in the complicated conundrum of FRBs. The research has been uploaded to preprint the server. It's called ARXIV, where they're trying to interpret this particular frequency. It goes into saying, it's easy to become somewhat obsessed with fast radio bursts. This is according to NASA and Chime, this particular company that discovered this. It says, a fascinating space mystery that has so far defied any attempts at a comprehensive explanation. It says, to recap, FRBs are hugely energetic flares of radiation in the radio spectrum that just a few milliseconds at most. And in that time frame, they can discharge as much power as hundreds of millions of suns.
Exactly.
And I will provide the link for this too. This was mind blowing for me. So we can only imagine the impact that these radio frequency signals are having on our melanin.
So as you see, radio frequencies is coming from as above, down to earth. And then you have this Bill Gates dude and his
companies
trying to produce an artificial radioactive, you know what I'm saying, active gridlock upon us.
Yep. Yep.
So this is what I was talking about. This is 5G versus 5D.
That's right.
Let's talk about the defense system that's up too. What was that we found out about the grid that's around the globe?
It's Dr. Elin Freeland. Dr. Elin Freeman, I think is her name. She released all of the information that they have put a fence up around Earth. And this energetic fence is up there to block, block what is gonna help us to break out of this prison. And so the space fence that they put up, and Trump also called to put together the Space Force. What the Space Force is being put in place for is to protect the space fence that was put up So we have the space fence that is trying to block this. And then we also have the chem domes that are using it. So they're working on different dimensions of the cosmos. And so, but with that being said, from what I have been getting with the space fence being up, we no longer, because, you know, they don't even talk about, what was it called? They used to talk about it, protect the earth. It protects us from radiation, the ozone layer.
Right.
They never talk about it anymore.
Because the ozone layer has been depleted.
It's been completely depleted. And when they depleted that, thanks to our ancestors and a lot of the help that we have outside of our light spectrum,
exactly.
They are using that to actually benefit us. And so by them depleting that, that was to protect them. It was never there to protect melanated people.
Right.
Exactly.
So they didn't put this fence up to try to protect them because the ozone layer is gone.
Exactly. And that's the truth of the matter. And in fact, I have an article concerning that. Let me see if I can pull that article up right quick. Because that is something in which that is dealing with the same information about the ozone layer and what is really taking place right now.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely.
So let me see here. All right, it says ozone hole is 3 times the size of Greenland over the North Pole.
Mm.
Wow.
Mm.
This is what the article says.
Wow.
It was saying that the ozone was closing.
Mm-hmm.
So it says this ozone holes open over the South Pole every year. So it's the North Pole, it's the South Pole too.
Mm-hmm.
And this is what the article says. Scientists have detected what may be the largest hole in the ozone layer ever recorded over the North Pole.
Wow.
Ever recorded. Now, back in the 70s, they said that because we use kerosene in our afros and we just spray the hell out of it. Remember? They said because we were spraying it, the monofluorocarbons went up into the atmosphere and depleted the ozone.
Mm-hmm.
That is the dumbest shit. That's just like what they told us about these Chinese eating these damn bats, or the damn monkey biting the nigga in his ass in Africa and that gave him AIDS. These are some of this. This is the dumbest bullshit theories that these Albions comes up with.
Mm-hmm.
In order to see how dumb the populace really is.
Mm-hmm.
Right? Really what happened is that the solar winds destroyed the ozone so that we can receive direct energies from Sirius and from Orion and from the various other constellations.
That's right.
But these are message codes, and we as melanated people are to receive these message codes directly.
Mm-hmm.
That's right.
This is what is going on. So this is what it says. It says ozone holes cut an area roughly 3 times the size of Greenland. Scientists from the European Science Agency said in a statement, and could expose people living as far north latitudes to high levels of ultraviolet radiation if it grows much larger.
Mm.
Wow.
All right.
Thus, they had to build technology to help protect themselves from that.
Right.
The space fence.
Yeah.
When was this article published? This article was published 2 days ago.
Wow.
By Ryan Spector, science writer.
Wow.
So, during the same time as Betelgeuse, let the sun shine in.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
So as Betelgeuse is putting off this energy, 2 days ago, who passes?
Kalindi Ihi.
Yeah.
Baba Kalindi Ihi passes 2 days ago.
Mm. Yeah.
Article is put out
there
about this whole.
Woo! They done messed up, boy, because that space military they got ain't nothing compared to what we got.
And this is why on April the 7th, 8:30 to 9 o'clock in the morning, I had a vision of UFOs appearing in the sky.
Mm.
These UFOs,
I did too.
These UFOs are the ancestors that's passed on.
I was just going to say that.
Yep.
Our ancestors are the bioexorcists.
Yes.
Yep.
We working with them.
Exactly. Mm-hmm. So it was myself, my wife, and about 15 to 20 others. We were standing outside of a brick bay building, and we all looked up to the sky, and as we looked up, UFOs just started to appear from another dimension into the sky on the astral plane, in the astral plane world. As wow. we looked,
that's
as we looked towards the front of us, U.S. troops was coming. We looked up towards us, and the jet planes was attempting to do battle, which was futile. Didn't have whatsoever on these ancestors or on these ships. Had no effect whatsoever.
Mm.
These are the sacrifices that you're talking about, the deaths. But these deaths, they are coming back as fighters, warriors.
Yes.
All right?
Yep. And which in the Bible is supposed to be the saints returning with Christ to the war. Saints
or the angels.
There you go.
Ancestors. Now, Goddess, I just didn't have that dream. Brother King Simon, we built on this yesterday. He had the same exact dream the same day. Now, April the 7th was the day of the super pink moon.
Yep. And look, I dreamed it 3 days before that, and then I dreamed of the super pink moon 3 times, and it's on the channel. I posted it every time I kept dreaming about it because I couldn't figure out what was going on. It's funny you say that, because on April 7th, a whole fleet of ships was seen in Brazil, and they went and scrubbed all the information. I happened to catch them few video clips. Brazil,
and they were seen over Detroit, Michigan.
Mm-hmm. Yep, sure was. Yep.
Now tell everybody what was your dream about concerning the UFOs, guys. You said you dreamt it about 3 days before that. So that was 3 days before. So that was a week before. And then, so that was a week ago.
Do a UFO search in your phone. Right.
Tell us what you seen in your vision.
So in my vision, the UFOs basically explained to me the cloaking system that they had been using.
Yeah.
And they said that they've been here. And as our Merkaba has been activating on Earth, as above, so below. Yeah. And they specifically said to me, because after I had the dream, we walked outside and we saw them. Some of them were pyramid or triangle shaped.
Yep.
And after we walked outside and saw them, you know, being Earnest and the kids, we knew it was a good thing, you know, it wasn't any fear or anything. Exactly. So I went into meditation to find out, to get some more information about that. And specifically, they said to me that we are the watchers. We are the ascended masters. We are taking note and we are keeping up with everything that is happening. And in the meditation, as they were communicating this to me, they placed me in a void of utter darkness, the blackest pitch black I had ever seen. And so the bottom of where I was sitting was taken out from under me, and I began to fear that I was going to float away in space. And so one of the watchers said to me, he says, daughter, he said, this is what we are trying to change. We are trying to deliver you all from fear, because this is the true virus that is getting in the way. Who told you that if there's nothing under you, that you're going to float away in the cosmos, that you got to be sitting on something? He said, we need you to challenge your programs, because we have not been able, we want to communicate with more of you in dreams and visions, But we can't. And so he said, y'all got to get rid of the lies. Whatever you was told about gravity, it don't apply to you the way it was taught to you. When we bring you to the astral realm and when we meet you with a dream, we need you to let go of all of the programs of the physics that you have been taught, because what we are doing supersedes that. And so what ended up happening was, about 6 months ago, this was the first time that what I call my galactic ancestors popped up on me. Remind me of Delvin Blair's story. He had a huge afro, brown skin, tall, slender black man with a huge afro. And his ship landed in our house. Some way he came through the roof, dematerialized, and landed in the house. And so he put a projection on the wall. And he said, I want you to pay attention to this. And he said, please tell me that y'all have started meditating. And I said, yes, we have started meditating. He said, okay, let me tell you the next thing. Create a sanctuary. Whatever you imagine in your mind gives birth to the nations that we're trying to access with you. He said, so create, if you have it in your meditation, create a sanctuary for you to go to be cleansed of all of the stuff that's being attacked and put on y'all. And so I was like, okay, I keep a dream journal. I wrote that down. The third thing he said to me, which I still have not decoded yet, but he said, please tell me you know who this entity is. And he pointed to a name, but I could only make out the letter A, which was the beginning of it. But he said that he could not say the name out loud. And he said, you should not say the name out loud. He said, there are some names that should not be said out loud. He said, but I need my people to become aware of this entity. And it began with an A. Hadn't decoded that part yet, but ever since then, he comes to me, not usually when I call. I guess he comes when he needs to. But the last time he came to me, he came with a briefcase, and he had someone in the ship with him. And inside, they opened the briefcase to let me see. And it was a crystal in the briefcase, but it looked like nothing I had ever seen before. And at this time, we were practicing Hebrew Israelite. And so I interpreted as the 12 tribes of Judah and the jewels that are on the breastplate. But this crystal was fire red. I mean, bright fire, cherry red. And it had like phantoms in the inside of it. And I was so in awe of the crystal, I reached to grab it. And he said, no. He said, you are not allowed to touch this. Y'all not ready for this yet, but we're getting you ready. And I said, well, what's the big deal about this crystal? Close the briefcase, put a code in it, locked it, and that was it. And he said, I can't tell you any more than that. So when I listened to you and Brother Panic, both of you all were mentioning the crystalline structure that we are turning, you know, into. And then you all also mentioned the color red and how important that is in relation to Betelgeuse. So that made me remember that crystal that I was shown.
Right. And so the crystal was reddish.
Yep. It was fire. It looked like fire was in the inside of it with phantom images, bright like cherry red. And well, I searched high and low. I cannot find a crystal on Earth that looks anything like this crystal.
The reason why is because that's the internal crystal, which is your kundalini.
So that's the crystalline structure, which in the Bible they call heaven, and they talk about the crystal gates.
Right.
And okay, makes sense. Because we do have crystals within the Bible.
Right, exactly.
Makes sense.
It is 144,000 crystals at the root chakra. It's called the Kunta gland, in which that is
1,000
crystals, and the kundalini color is red. So those 2,000 crystals must be risen up with the kundalini to reach the other 72,000 crystals that's around the pineal gland to give us the 144,000 crystals, hence symbolic to the 144,000. Which is mentioned in the book of Revelation.
I got some screenshots because the watcher gave me some of that information too. And I always ask for a sign. And within 24 hours, I had so many screenshots and synchronicities and symbols coming through. I just started screenshotting it. And I came to understand that. And I also came to understand that he said it's very important right now that we resurrect love and heal between the divine masculine and divine feminine who are in incarnated bodies right now. He said it's very important that you all begin working on the balance and the harmony between your relationships. He said, because this is key, and this is why they came against the relationship between the black man and the black woman. And so after I wrote that down, it probably took 6 to 8 months after that, I discovered the circuitry of the body and the nadis. And it was one of your lectures that confirmed this information. And after it was confirmed, I released it. But there are 72,000 circuits within the body. And so if you take the divine masculine incarnate and the divine feminine incarnate, and when they come together as one, that's also the 144,000. And from my understanding, this circuitry has been short-circuited, but what's happening with Betelgeuse is going to stop the short circuits. And so that's why you hear a lot of black people say, my nerve's bad, my nerve's bad. He says that the nervous system is having to be regenerated and healed because of all of the the generational trauma that you have experienced. He said that was definitely a strategy. And so we must heal the nervous system so that you all can conduct the amount of energy to activate the light body. And he said within the church, this is what they call the glorified body. So he said, I want to interpret that for you, what that really means. And at this point, that's when I realized that a divine couple, a black man and a black woman coming together, trying to build an economy, trying to enlighten others and teach us information, and also humbling ourselves to each other and being in our heart with each other to heal is very important to heal the generational trauma. And the watcher specifically said to me, the attack is against that. So to focus on that. And for the people who are single and have not reunited with their divine masculine, divine feminine counterpart, he says, begin doing the work with yourself within your higher self, balancing a divine masculine and divine feminine so that it will open up for you to receive that person that is a match for you. And this connects back to Isis and Osiris and Aset and Osir. It connects all back to what that really means and what that is. Unfortunately, I do a lot of reading, so a lot of people are getting divorces right now and are breaking up. But the reason that that is happening is because a lot of us, under the programs that we were under, we got with karmic people. They were karmic relationships to clear karmic debt and learn lessons. But we misinterpreted those situations as soulmates or twin flames. And so now the great separation is happening so that we can be reunited with the one that's going to help us to not only activate each other, but to bring the children, the souls of the children forth of two people who are woke with this knowledge is going to change the kind of souls that are going to come here.
Beautifully said. That's exactly what's happening.
And one last thing, if I'm talking too much, y'all, let me know.
Fine, do your thing.
Okay.
Yeah,
I'm still coming out of some of the religious programming that the woman ain't supposed to teach, so bear with me.
She got that gift like this, so hey.
I'm about to say, not from the videos I've seen.
Yeah. I'm working on it. So this connects to the great disclosure. Now in 2019, they told me that 2019 going into 2020 would be the year of fear. Every year that it begins, they give me something to understand what the transformation within that year. So they said 2019 into 2020 would be the year of fear. So if you look back at 2019, there were more fear tactics than anything we have ever seen. We were hit with it on every level that you could possibly think of, from what happened with the abortion clinics to the information that began to get out about all the young girls going missing. It was a lot of fear. And so what they were doing was trying to recycle the reincarnation process using fear, and they were going to transmute this fear and this distress that they were creating in 2019 to be used to amplify the magic of what they're doing in 2020. So with that being said, they explained to me that the disclosure that we've been talking about for many years, we've been waiting on Area 51 to do the disclosure and the CIA to do the disclosure. They said that's not how it's going to happen. The disclosure takes place in your DNA.
Exactly.
So this led me to Kanye West and Katy Perry. You can plug it up right here. Kanye West and Katy Perry had a song that came out in 2010 that translates to the awakening on a mass level of star seeds, the energy of Aset and Osir. And so the lyrics to that, I'm going to let you read, babe, because, you know, my vision ain't that good up close. Right here on this side. Yeah.
Okay. He said, you're so hypnotizing. Could you be the devil? Could you be an angel? Your touch magnetizing. Feels like I'm floating. Leaves my body glowing. They say, be afraid. You're not like the others. Futuristic lovers.
Mm.
Different DNA. They don't understand you. You're from a whole other world. A different dimension. You open my eyes and I'm ready to go. Lead me into the light. Kiss me. Kiss me. Infect me with your love and fill me with your poison. Take me to take me. Want to be a victim? Ready for abduction. Boy, you're an alien. Your touch so foreign. It's supernatural, extraterrestrial. You're so supersonic. Want to feel your powers. Stun me with your lasers. Your kiss is cosmic. Every move is magic. You're from a whole other world, a different dimension. You open my eyes and I'm ready to go. Lead me into the light. Kiss me. Kiss me. Infect me with your love and fill me with your poison. Take me. Take me. Want to be your victim? Ready for abduction. Boy, you're an alien. Your touch so foreign. It's supernatural, extraterrestrial. This is transcendental on another level. Boy, you're my lucky star. I want to walk on your wavelength and be there when you vibrate.
Woo!
Yeah, she was coming.
Woo!
She said, for you, I risk it all. All. Kiss me. Kiss me. Infect me with your love and fill me with your poison. Take me. Take me. Want to be your victim, ready for abduction. And it just go on. That's the chorus. Yeah. Yeah.
Let me start that next section after that. Yeah. Okay. Wow.
Yeah. So, yeah, those were the lyrics of the Kanye West and Katy Perry song.
Okay.
I thought Juice was on it. Not that much. Kanye was on it?
And then if you read from some of it. This Mind and Healing. This is the book of occult healing.
Oh, okay.
Hopefully we still on. Look like Dr. Bay may have stepped away for a second. Hopefully y'all can still hear us. But I want to say that a lot of things have to be hidden in the music, again, because the music is being used as a weapon against us, which is why they use 440 hertz instead of 432. Yeah. And we know that 432 is a vibration of harmony, and 440 is a vibration of dissonance. And so a lot of times the downloads and the light activations that we require are hidden in these songs, and they have someone like Katy Perry sing it, which is going to make most conscious people steer away from even paying any attention to that.
Right.
So this is the trickery and the deception of how they hide things in plain sight. So thanks to the ancestors and my spirit guides that led me to that. But the point in that is, we are stars, that the supernova is coming, and that she talked about the virus and the poison, and to infect me and to feel me, that is supernatural and it's extraterrestrial, is transcendental. So this was just an awakening for us to begin to deeply understand and understand that we are star seeds and we are not from here. Many of us are from Orion's Belt and are Syrians. Yes. So that was the importance of that song.
Exactly. Can y'all still hear me?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, we can hear it.
No doubt about it. And here's an article from New York Times. All right, this is the New York Times, y'all. It says, waiting for Betelgeuse to explode. It says, a fading giant. Around 700 years ago, the red giant Betelgeuse began to fade. The light from that unusual dimming is only now reaching Earth.
Wow.
It's only now reaching Earth. So we know that we are in this time of Betelgeuse, which is Asaru.
Right.
It says some 700 light years away, Betelgeuse is normally one of the 10 brightest stars in the sky, but is now fainter than ever recorded.
Yeah.
So it says, it goes on, we continue on here. And so when we get to Betelgeuse, we find out something. It says Betelgeuse was named after the Betelgeuse star, a star in the Orion constellation. The reasoning behind this is that Betelgeuse is supposed to be the doorway to the infinite blackness of outer space.
That's the void that Watcher took me to.
A metaphor for Betelgeuse becomes the doorman underworld. So the doorman is here to open the door, which is the portal, the stargate.
Yeah.
But Bill Gates is here as the Antichrist with his technology as the gatekeeper, the blocky, as you've seen, the blocky sun. So see, this is who we're fighting against, is the Antichrist consciousness.
That's so true.
Yeah. That's right. It's very significant that you pointed that out. Because one thing that I found was that with this particular vaccination that Bill Gates is coming up with, in 2015, if I'm not mistaken, Siri, this is when Siri was introduced to her, to us. And if you look at Siri, you got Iris, and Iris is I, as in Eye of Ra. You can also move those letters around and get Siri, as in Sirius or Sirius B, energy. But with all that being said,
Iris. Oz Iris become Osiris.
There you go.
Right.
Siri said that the gates of hell was going to open that year. This was 2015, if I'm not mistaken.
Right.
Everybody, it went viral, and everybody was excited about having this android, that this AI you could talk to will answer anything, and you can watch the videos. She specifically said that the gates of Hades was about to be opened, and that it was intentional. And I'm beginning to think this connect back to Bill Gates.
Yeah, and it makes sense. Because as we continue on, check this out. It says, from IndieWire, the title for Betelgeuse is a play on the character Betelgeuse name, which in turn is based on the Betelgeuse star, which is housed in the infinite blackness of space, but in the same constellation as the most famous star, Orion.
Wow. they did a number with their movie, didn't they?
Huh?
I said they did a number with their movie.
Yeah, they did. You know what I'm saying? And so Tim Burton, who did this, he did this. He said right here, he said the reason the director Tim Burton decided to title the film Betelgeuse opposed to Betelgeuse is actually very straightforward. Betelgeuse sound funnier for the younger audience, and Betelgeuse is a lot easier to remember, pronounce, and spell compared to Betelgeuse. It says the film studio actually disliked the title and considered renaming the picture House Ghosts. As a bit of Mickey take, director Tim Burton put forward the idea Scared Sheetless. What was horrified when he discovered that the studio was actually considering it. So as you can imagine, the original intent of Tim Burton was to name the film Betelgeuse, but they later decided on the name change for the movie, but not the for the title character. Hence why you see Betelgeuse in the TV advent and the gravestone. Confusing for those who don't know, but actually pretty straightforward for those who know or who do know. All right, so they told you right there, there are those who know and those who don't know.
Don't know, right.
Right? So, you know, so what is it that we know and, you know, that some of us know and some of us don't know? Well, right here, it says that Orion, the constellation, is called the Hunter. Now, this ain't no accident that they come out with the Hunt, the movie The Hunt, during the same time period.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
You know,
just talking
about that. Yeah.
Right. This is no coincidence.
Mm-hmm.
You know?
That is so true. And another thing we found, another thing that we noticed and we found from watching the Betelgeuse movie, it's two things happening. It's the spiritual side of it and the physical side of it, and how they're both being shut down and updated or rebirthed, if we want to use that word. Just like how you mentioned that the global system, the economy of the whole global system is being reset.
Right.
The caseworker in the movie, she made a statement and she was like, "You better be glad that y'all didn't die in Italy." She was talking to the undead couple, the deceased couple.
Right.
She said she mentioned to them that they better be glad that they didn't die in Italy. The key word was Italy,
because
we know that Italy was the first country that had full lockdown, the most number of cases of the coronavirus.
Right.
And then when we looked, it was another point in the movie to where when they first started having the little phenomena and realizing that they were actually dead. They didn't know that they were dead. And then the husband, I think he went out the door and he went to a whole other dimension. And then the wife opened the door and ended up snatching him back into the house. And then when she went in the other room and she showed him the mirror, they didn't have a reflection in the mirror. And then she showed him the book. And this book was, what was the name of the book? It was entitled,
Recently Deceased.
Yeah, and he called, we talking about somebody who got understanding.
Right.
He intentionally called that word disease.
Right.
He spoke there. He said, the guy for the recently diseased. And then the wife turned around and corrected him and said deceased.
Right.
Now we find that real strange that he mentioned disease and in the midst of what has happened since Betelgeuse has came into our galaxy.
Exactly.
With this disease.
And guess what, guy? The Betelgeuse movie can't be found nowhere online unless you have to pay for it. It's not free any longer anywhere online.
You sure?
Yep. Right. Ever since we put this information out, it's not free.
Yep.
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 You sure right. You sure right.
And one other thing that stood out too, when you look at the book of the recently deceased, we know everything is inside out. What's bad is good, good is bad, you know, all of that. But with that being said, to me, that pointed us back to the book of the dead.
Yep. Right.
And so the overstanding of that is the couple that moved into the home were on a 3D wavelength, very materialistic. They appeared to be alive, but because they were unconscious of the spiritual realm the other couple encountered, they were actually the ones who are dead. Right. And so those who think they're alive are dead. Exactly. And those that is considered dead, because we are being reborn, we have been going through a death to be rebirthed. Mm-hmm. We are those who are actually living, because we're aware of both dimensions and the underworld.
Exactly.
And then check out the other instance where the wife, especially for those of you that maybe haven't seen the movie since you was a child or something like that, you know what I'm saying? But the wife got the husband a gift, and the gift that she got him was called Manchurian Tongue Well. Mm. Now, when you look up what tongue well, the Manchurian part can throw you off, but it's the tongue well. And it's what that is. It's actually tongue oil, is what that references, even though he called it Manchurian tongue well. Because what the gift was something to apply to the, you know, tongue oil is used to coat things. It's like, if you've ever seen any of those Asian, what is it? They have pitchers, they have clocks, but it looked like it got a big, thick, wet layer on it, but it's really just a coating. That's what the tongue oil is, and that's what it's used for. It's used for coating. And the fact that it was Manchuria. Now, Manchuria is in Northeast China. And so that also ties, they were speaking that, the fact that he called it Manchurian tongue well.
Right.
Mm-hmm. After he didn't say disease.
And Italy.
And it's all coming from China.
It's right. And it was all in the movie. That's why they took it down from being free, since we won't be able to go back and decode it unless we pay for it, of course.
Yep. Yeah.
And then that way they can track who went and purchased it, so that they'll know who up to date on what's really going on.
Exactly.
Yep.
Exactly. But they already know we on it.
Right.
Yeah. Yep. I think the cat's out the bag at this point, yeah. Dr. Bay.
Oh, yeah.
Matter of fact, the cat is scratching.
There you go.
Yep.
And one other thing that stood out about that was the fact that he had on black and white. We know black and white stripes can represent the prison. Prison can represent prison planet. Mm-hmm. Being that he was a bioexorcist, to me that says biologically, we are being exorcised to be released from the prison planet. And another thing was they found him within a graveyard, which was where he was existing. Right. So again, this just takes you back to rebirth, death, and the funerary rites of ancient Egypt and the Book of the Dead.
Right.
The coming forth by day.
Right, coming forth day and night, exactly.
That's right. Mm-hmm. That's right.
Indeed.
And one other thing, their daughter, she wore all black, so she was with the primordial energy of the divine feminine. She was with the energy of death and understood that it was required for the cycles of life. She was the only one that could see them, and she made a statement that stood out to us, but she said, living people ignore the strange and unusual. And she said, because I'm unusual, I can see you. That was cold.
Right.
That takes me back to Bobby Hemmett,
right,
where he says, if you can imagine it, and Brother C. Freeman L., if you can imagine it in your mind, it don't matter how strange it is, that means that it's real. It's more real than the simulated reality that you exist in every day. So the key thing about that is the Bible talks about being peculiar people, being unusual people, being strange people. And so this is why we are being able to tap into this. So with all of that being said, that led me to the book called The Occult Healing, The Occult Principles of Health and Healing. And again, we're going to put this information up on our website, because this book was actually really hard to find. But The Occult Principles of Health and Healing specifically talks about fear and the way it impacts the body. It also talks about viruses and the impact of that on a cellular level. If I could just try to skip through some of this, which I thought was very powerful. But it says that how the body will quickly expel food and certain things from the body once you become selective and excrete the waste matter while retaining the vital substances necessary for the economy of the body. But the moment we allow thoughts of fear, of worry, of anger, the body endeavors, as it were, to close the gates against an outside foe who has been fancied or real. Then also the spleen closes up and ceases to specialize the vital fluid in sufficient quantities for the necessities of the body. And we then see a phenomenon which is analogous to the effect of lowering the voltage or cutting in more resistance in the electric fan. In that case, the paper streamers will begin to hang down. They will no longer wave over the candy or fruit to protect it from fruit flies. Similarly, in the human body, when the thought of fear forces the partial closure of your spleen, the solar fluid does not go through the body with the same speed as before. It's more if you want me to read the rest of it. Okay. It says it does not then radiate from the periphery in straight lines, but these lines become crumpled and thus they allow easy access to the little deleterious organisms which may then feed unobstructed upon our tissues and cause dis-ease. Whether the consistent mental scientists or others who believe in divine healing know this law or not, they act according to it dictates when they affirm that they are children of God, that they have no reason to fear. For God is the Father and will protect them so long as they do not deliberately disregard the ordinary laws of life in the universe. The actual fact and the truth in the matter is that contagion comes from within. So long as we live a common sense life, feeding our bodies upon the pure foods which come from the vegetable kingdom, taking a sufficient amount of exercise, and keeping mentally active, we may rest secure in the promise that the Lord is our refuge. There shall no evil befall us so long as we thus show our faith by these works. On the other hand, if we believe our faith in God by disregard of his laws or expectations of health are in vain. As a man thinketh in his heart, so is he, said the Christ. And this is absolutely scientific proposition. Something moreover, which everyone may demonstrate by looking about in him, the everyday conditions of life in the home, office, or street. Here we see a man with thick lips, with puffed cheeks, with a vertebral pouch under his chin, and at once we know that we have before us a glutton and a sensualist. Another comes along the street. His face is furrowed by lines. His lips are thin and set, and we know that thought and care have been the architects that have molded these wrinkles in the face. And we know black don't crack. So this, all this information, you know, within this occult healing principles of health and healing book, this is page 178, in case somebody has it or wants to find it. So the coping system and everything, all of that food has been set up to lower the voltage that our body can handle.
Exactly. That's the reason why we have GMO food. Mm-hmm. Why there's chemtrails in the sky and why there's fluoride in the water.
Yep. Yep.
No, that's the reason why, is to make sure that we are being attacked constantly. And so cells, when they scientifically analyze them, bacteria spores, aluminum, barium, thorium, zirconium, and other refractive metals and metals oxides have been found.
What they also found is, like you said, that there's nanobot technology, self-replicating nanobot technology. With rivers of silicon running wild through the bodies of Melungeon infested people. Mm-hmm. This is how it looks. This nano communication array, this is blown up 60 times.
Yeah. It looked like the more generous.
Yeah, we have some pictures of that in the coronavirus documentary. Earnest put together very similar pictures. One thing that was very interesting was one of the men who suffered from this Morgellons, from these nanobots. He's a remote viewer. He actually practices the cult, and he drew images of what these nanobots look like. And he specifically said that they were a splice between an entity that is organic and AI combined.
I tell you what, allow me to share an image, and I'll share it right quick.
Go ahead.
Okay.
This was deep. He went inside his body to draw a picture. He happens to be a very, very good artist. Draw a picture of what these nanobots look like. And the picture that you shown was exact, but it had a face to it. And when you look at the picture.
It said I can't share it. Because
can you pull the picture up and put it up to the phone?
I can. I'll do that.
Okay. Yeah. And I'm gonna add one more thing while he pulls up that picture so y'all can see this. But the effects of fear on the body.
Can y'all see
that's the picture?
Yeah, that's it. Yeah, look, entity. Yeah. Arcon.
Yeah. Yep.
Right. That's an
Arcon. Very intelligent.
Right.
Yeah. And they're colonizers.
It looked like a spider or something. Right. Yep. Right. Yeah. Yep.
Which is why they've been pushing the black people love chicken thing for many, many years. Chicken, you know, causes a lot of mucus in the body.
Right.
And this wasn't set up.
Exactly.
We need to stop saying that black folks love chicken. We might used to, but black folks love, we want to live.
We love chicken nowadays.
We love tomatoes.
Is that, we love
there chicken. There you go. Yeah. Zucchini.
Exactly. Yeah.
Yo.
No, that's right.
You know what I'm saying?
But also from the occult healing book, this chapter is called The True Cause of a Contagion. And it says that there are many people of a supercilious nature who are always ready to crack a joke at the expense of those who practice occult methods of divine healing, which teach one to cultivate a fearless attitude of mind under all conditions. But as a matter of actual fact, an enormous percentage of our sickness is actually due and traceable to feelings of fear upon the part of the patient. It says travelers who have visited uninhabited islands report that the birds and beasts found there were unafraid of them at first, but they soon learned the predatory nature of man and fled before him in fear of their lives. Thus, the ruthless nature of man has in ages past spread fear all over the earth, even among the animal kingdom. We have conquered, tamed, and exploited, here we go, both bird and beast, and what we could not conquer, we have slain, until every breathing thing hides in fear of us. That is to say, among the larger animals, none is so large that it does not fear us and flee from us. When we turn in the direction of the little things, then the case is different. Man, who thinks he reigns supreme on earth because he has put all the larger creation in a state of fear, trembles in turn before the minute things in the world, the minuscule things in the world, and the smaller they are, the more he fears them. This is why they use the coronavirus to strike so much fear, because it's small and it cannot be seen by the naked eye.
Right.
It says the microscope has told us that such a small creature as the house fly carries about on the fur of its legs thousands of parasites. and it goes on and on. But the reason that the fly part is significant is because flies and mosquitoes have been turned into a system to be used to oversee us outside of the cameras and the phones. They have put these devices where house flies have these nanobots, and we have proof of this in this documentary. The nanobots get inside the house fly
or the flea or the gnat
and take over the body and eat it and take over the body and replicate. And so it looks like a fruit fly or mosquito, but it's really a nanobot because it knows how to take over the system of these particular insects.
Mm-hmm. We seen that parasite that was inside the praying mantis that was larger than the praying mantis.
Huge.
All right, so we get ready to close it on up in a few here. So before we go, my last comments are this. There was an article that came out 6 years ago, November the 18th, 2014, and it says Black people have superpowers. White people from Time Live. 5 studies have found that white people tend to believe that Black people may have superhuman abilities.
Oh, yeah.
Wow. So they already believe that we have these superhuman abilities. So obviously they seen us do some miraculous shit.
Right, mm-hmm. Right.
All right.
That go back to Henrietta Lacks herself, still doing miraculous shit to this day.
Yep.
Exactly. Matter of
fact, cells won't die.
The 2 strands of DNA is called the helix strands.
Mm-hmm.
After her, Henrietta Lacks, helix.
That's right. That's right.
So it says a research paper published in Journal Personality Science claimed that it was the first empirical investigation into human superhumanization or the attribution of supernatural, extrasensory, and magical mental and physical qualities to humans.
Wow.
So
this is an article that they did 6 years ago, and white people believe that we got powers already.
Wow.
All right.
And we do.
And I'm getting ready to prove it.
How hard was it for you to find that information?
It wasn't hard.
You had to search.
It wasn't hard. It was right up in there.
Wow.
Yep, just hit up search and put that in.
Yeah.
So here it is. The true third secret of Fatima revealed in the return of Christ. This is Pastor Milo Zijitu, Josiah. And it says, Simon Kambangu was a prophet. He was left to rot and tortured in prison. He died October 1951 after 30 years. There are Africans alive at this writing, which was brought back from the dead by Simon Kambangu.
Mm.
There are people still living who watched him do it. The claim is that Simon Kambangu healed the sick, made the lame walk, returned sight to the blind, and hearing to the deaf, and even brought a dead infant back 3 days back to life. Now, if you don't understand that, these are the exact same miracles that they said Jesus did.
Right, exactly.
Mm-hmm. So this is why I say that this is Homo Christos. This is what is getting ready to happen. We getting ready to become like this.
Yeah.
Kambangu performed these miracle deeds over a period, miraculous deeds over a period of 5 months from May 1921 through September the 12th, 1921. Scholars do not dispute that this man performed these miracles because there is simply too much testimony about it.
Mm-hmm.
Wow.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Then you have the emergence of African avatars and The Secret of Fatima by Tom in Nexus Magazine. All right, now this is one of my favorite. Simeon Toko. He's born February 24th, Pisces, 1918 through 1984. Simeon Toko appeared before people in an aboriginal body and dream state while he was physically alive and can do so to several after certain selective people 17 years after his natural death.
at least one witness said he personally killed Simeon Toko. He said one witness said he killed him professionally, quite professionally, that is, as a killer, and saw him alive back a few days later. Still living at the writer saw Toko physically slaughtered and watched him bring himself back to life before their astonished eyes.
Wow.
And these are just some of the fantastic stories that we heard.
Yeah.
Simeon Toko unleashed his army. The event was witnessed by thousands of people on January the 4th, 1954. On that day, the cherubims and seraphims appeared and stood before the Belgian colonial army. The citizens of Leopoldville saw a thousand small brown men, all right, about the size of children.
Wow.
Right? These are who we would call the Twa people.
Yeah.
All right. It says they was very muscular and imposing bodies. Each of them, diminutive, human-looking creatures showed great strength. For example, a witness saw one flip a 5-ton truck over with one arm. The Belgian soldiers fired at these little brown angels to no effect. Terrified. This is the same thing that we was talking about when they went up against these UFOs that I seen in the dream on April the 7th, had no effect. Terrified, the colonial army was thrown into confusion. The little men disappeared as suddenly as they appeared. The 1 year after that amazing mass apparition, the Democratic Republic of Congo was a new and an independent country. Because this one man did these things, it gained them freedom. Just one.
Yeah.
Wow.
Just one. Yeah.
Just one.
Take one to slay 1,000 and two to slay 10,000.
Right. All right. During a stay in Angola in 1994, 10 years after Toko's death, Pastor Kahani reported a Portuguese foreman held Simeon Toko and set him up to crawl under the blade of a seed sower. When he was under the engine, the foreman sitting in the driver's seat started it up, severing into pieces the body of Simeon Toko. Terrified, Kahani stood frozen to the spot watching. The foreman shift into reverse to back it up and change and check the damage. All right. Then the unbelievable happened. Before Kahani's and the two Portuguese accomplices, the body of Simeon Toko recomposed itself. And Simeon Toko stood up and Kahani could not believe his eyes. The Portuguese ran away in fear, in terror, From that day on, Kahani believed in the Lord and his entire family converted to the church of Simeon Toko.
Wow.
Right? Now, this is the same thing that we read in Matthew, the 12th chapter, the 24th verse, 25th verse. But when the Pharisees heard it, that he said that the fellow does not cast out devils, but by Beelzebub, the prince of the devil. And Jesus knew their thoughts and said to them, every kingdom divided against itself is brought to desolation. And every city and house divided against itself shall not stand. And if Satan casts out Satan, he is divided against himself. How shall then his kingdom stand? Matthew 24. Think of that I cannot pray to my Father, and he shall presently give me more than 12 legions of angels. So here it is.
Wow.
Simeon Toko called forth these angels, these 1,000 small little brown angels. Cherubim, seraphims, who was able to turn goddamn a 5-ton truck over with one arm. And bullets could not penetrate them. Had no effect whatsoever.
That reminds me of the soldiers, the young children soldiers over in Africa in the Syrian war. You know, they said they had became cannibals and they were eating hearts and things like that, but they had superpowers.
Exactly.
And you said 5 again. I don't want to forget this because this was important for me to present. In 2011, I had a dream that I saw a black woman in a wheelchair dying. and it was me and about 11 other people, and we were out in the wilderness, but where we were standing, we were able to see as if we were on Mount Shasta. So we could see from one side of the earth to the other and out into the cosmos. And this angel was teaching us to understand sound frequency. And he said, when the sound that's emitting from these planets and the new solar systems that are coming into your solar system, he said, it's gonna change the sound frequency. He said, if you take all of the frequencies of each planet and play them together, it's gonna play a certain rhythm and a certain music. Right. He said, but very soon, the fat lady goes to stop singing, so to speak. He said, the poles are gonna reverse. And he also said, the rotation of Earth is going to speed up, and that's gonna change the sound and vibration. So after he said this, he said, I wanna teach you how to measure the cosmos so that you will know the time and signs when this is nigh. And so I turned around to the black woman in the wheelchair, and she grabbed my hand and she said, baby, you gotta be the one that prayed me out. And I said, what do you mean? She said, well, it's time for me to go. And I said, okay, well, I'll pray for you. I got ready to pray for her. She said, no, you gotta wait until it's five. And I said, five what? She said, wait until it's five. So I just assumed it was 5 a.m. or 5 p.m. Now I understand that she represented the church. She was the death of the church. And she was saying that when 5D entered, that the church, the system, and the spell was going to be broken down. So I want to make sure I shared that prophetic dream, because it aligns to everything that's happening.
And too, God, is that just last week, we got a sister who comes and helps. Matter of fact, she's one of our co-partners in the business, her and my wife. She said that herself, her aunt, and her grandmother was outside one night, and they seen two UFOs in the sky. All right?
Wow. Yeah.
And they Christians, so they started calling on Jesus.
Wow.
They didn't have no effect on these UFOs. That
okay. Beetle Jesus.
Right, right. Exactly. Beetle Jesus. Jesus. Beetle Jesus. That's right. That's exactly who they need to call. That's exactly who they're calling upon. All right. So after they seen that. They was calling her up and asking all types of questions. Talking about there was submarines in the sky. They say, ain't no daggone submarines. That's the alien ships.
Yeah. That's crazy.
So that's what grandma was saying. There was submarines in the sky.
So, oh, wow.
You know, we might have to do a song about that. Submarines in the sky, y'all.
Yeah, right.
Yeah, you know me and Earnest both rap, so we can definitely get it in.
Uh-oh. Yeah. Hey, you know I do that too, so you know.
I know.
All right. So this is my last point. 1 Corinthians, the 12th chapter says, now concerning spiritual gifts, brethren, I will not have you ignorant. You know that you were Gentiles carried away with these dumb idols, even as you was led. Wherefore, I give you the understanding that no man speaking by the Spirit of God calling Jesus a curse, and that no man can say Jesus is the Lord but by the Holy Ghost. Now there are diversities of gifts, but the same Spirit, and there are different administrations, but the same Lord, and there are diversities of operation, but the same God that worketh all in all. But the manifestation of the Spirit is given to man to profit withal. For to one is given the spirit of the of words of wisdom, to another the words of knowledge by another the same Spirit, to another faith by the same Spirit, to another the gift by the same Spirit, to another the work of miracles, to another prophecy, to another discerning the spirits, to another diverse kinds of tongues, and to another interpretation of tongues. But all these worketh the one in the self same Spirit, divided to every man severely as he will. So as you will, the gifts in which that you take on, that's how you manifest the will of the Spirit of God. Is based on the gifts that you take on. Prophet, you will. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. So
that's right.
If people want it, they want it. They don't, then they don't get it.
Yeah.
That's right. That's right.
That is so true. Yeah.
You know? Yeah. So this is something too. This is the last thing too. David Icke, in his book, The Biggest Secret, he said on page 478, The Brotherhood has technology to mess with the weather, and they use it, no doubt about it. We have seen nothing yet. Enormous changes in climate patterns and extremes of weathers are likely in this period. Along with geological effects of the Earth restructures herself and prepares her body for the shift in the same way that humans are having to do. We and the Earth are being challenged to synchronize our consciousness and its physical expressions with the rapidly accelerating frequencies now bathing the planet. The Brotherhood are seeking desperately to hide these facts by blaming the weather changes on the greenhouse effect of El Nino. They know that once people realize something very different is happening, the dominoes will fall and the game will be up because the energy changes are waking people up. Beetlejuice is the one that's back to make sure that happens.
Where's that Beetlejuice?
Return of the Christ, for real. This is Return of the Christ.
Return of the real Mac.
Yeah. Exactly. All right, this is Return of the Ancient Ones. All right, so the Brotherhood knows that it was coming and with its effect would be. They couldn't jump into a spacecraft and fiddle with the sun. Remember, this is why Bill Gates was trying to block the sun. They couldn't jump and go and fuck with the sun. All right, it's 93 million miles away. Even if it's damn like the flat earthers say it's 3,000 miles away, they can't get up there and fuck with it.
It's just something you mentioned that I just came across some the other day that was talking about how much money Bill Gates has put into bunkers, building bunkers and underground facilities where like little groups of people can stay for a period of time. Right. Yeah. So he put a lot of money into it.
And so what it says is their only alternative was to hijack the awakening consciousness and lead into another cul-de-sac. This is what they did with what? They did that with the CERN. They did that with the Mandela effect. That's what they was attempting to do. And now with another rule and regulation religion, all right? Now you got to stand 6 feet apart. Social distancing. You need to stay in your home.
Yeah.
All these things is part of this. Where it would be no threat to the Brotherhood agenda. Why? Because they want to put up that 5G network to create a gridlock. Lockdown. Yeah. I'm going to get to that lockdown. Right in a second, he says we are clearly being prepared for revelations about these entities because the highly charged, higher frequency energies will increase dramatically. The number of people who see these entities of the lower fourth dimension, they need the microchip in place before they are seen openly as the vibratorial changes advance. Wow. All right, this is. This is what he says, all right?
Yeah.
So we know that this is going on right now, all right?
Yeah.
All right. What y'all got to say in closing?
Give me that last sheet. One last thing in closing. I want to say, that's it right there. I want to share this one thing about the solar plexus. I've been having to do a lot of solar plexus work lately, and I got a feeling maybe I'm not the only one.
Oh, me too. Me too.
Okay. Yeah. See, that's confirmation. So according to page 176 of the Occult Principles of Health and Healing, it's pertaining to the children of God. It says, it is well known to science that an attitude of fear breaks down the power of resistance of the body and thereby lays it liable to all diseases, which would not otherwise be able to gain a foothold. From the occult point of view, it is perfectly plain why this is so. The dense body, which we see with our eyes, is interpenetrated by a vehicle made of ether and the energy from the sun, which pervades all space, is constantly pouring into our body through the spleen, which is a specialized organ for the attraction and assimilation of this universal ether. In the solar plexus, it is converted into a rose-colored fluid, which permeates the nervous system. This may be compared to electricity in the wires of an electric or telegraphic system. By means of this vital fluid, the muscles are moved and the organs perform their vital functions so that the body may express itself in perfect health. The better the health, the larger the quantity of this solar fluid, which we are able to absorb, but we only utilize a certain part of it, and the surplus is radiated from the body in straight lines. And these are the rays of Ra depicted in what this is saying. It goes on to say, you have seen the paper ribbons fastened in front of an electric fan in stores. I read this part, but I missed this. It says the streamers which flow from the whole periphery of the human body also radiate in these straight lines for perfect health. So this goes back to sun gazing, and this goes back to the rays of Ra as well. And it says that no matter what the condition is, we speak of such a person as radiating life and vigor, and under such conditions, no disease, no germs can ever get a foothold in this body. They cannot enter from without because of these invisible streamers of force from the solar plexus, any more than a fly can enter an opening in a building covered by an exhaust fan.
The name of that book is Occult Principles of Health and Healing.
Good book.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
All right. And definitely y'all need to check out that book. All right. And this is it. Light Cold Lockdown. Right. This is what they're attempting to do. We just read, the God has just read that portion from the occult principles of health and healing from that book. And we just finished reading from The Biggest Secret by David Icke. And the whole thing is based on Light Cold Lockdown, which Baba Phil Valentine told us about damn near 20 years ago.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Right. And it says, atoms consist of particles not made of any material stuff. The discovery that mass, bah, human body is nothing more but a form of energy has forced us to modify our concept of a particle in an essential way. In modern physics, particles are seen as bundles of energy. If anything is going at the speed of light, then it must be completely massless. Photons, which is macabre meditation. All right, now we're talking about the macabre meditation. For those who know about Gervalo Melchizedek and has his book, Volume 1 and 2, A Flower, The Flower of Life, he goes in on the 18 breath technique for the macabre technique, but he also did the 24 and 28 breath technique. All right. But here, as objects travel faster and faster, they get heavier and heavier. The heavier they get, the harder it is to achieve acceleration. So you never get to the speed of light, says Roger Rasool, a physicist at the University of Melbourne, Australia. Now, comment, stars are not an isolated thermonuclear reaction in space. Instead, Roger Jurgen explains that stars are positive anodes in a galactic glow discharge. Stars are connected. Stars are connected. This is why we say that the stars are the minds of our ancestors. Mm-hmm. In fact, it shows you on the old Lion King that when Simba's father died, Mufasa, he became a star in the sky. That's right. The indigenous cultures around the world say that when you die, you become a star in the sky. Wow. This is why even the Albion in astronomy names the stars in the sky after people.
Mm-hmm.
Matter of fact, you can get your name, you can get a star name after you right now by calling the astronomy institute.
Mm-hmm.
Right? Mm-hmm. It says this is what stars are connected. They absorb energy from the electric universe. And this is explained in detail by the ancient Egyptian hieroglyphs. The cobra or snake, of course, Kundalini,
with its exothermal nature, are used to encircle the sun as what? As the corona. Seen as Ra, it described the first temperature gradient of electric stars and absorbed the energy from the surrounding cosmos. In short, stars are positively charged adenoids that collect negative energy as opposed charge attracts are what we understand as electron particles. Now, that is the same science that we understand when we say that right here, health is about light, not food. Like Dr. Jack Kurz. All right, we're talking about the science of the science in Egyptians. And here it is right here. We see that right here in the hieroglyph of Akhenaten and Nefertiti and their children with their hands up towards the sun and the sun filling up their cup. The cup is symbolic. Even though they have cups in their hands, technically the cup is symbolic. The cup symbolizes their chakras, their body. Right? And so this is the same thing we see over and over again, and that your body is 93% stardust material. You know what I'm saying? And we have to thank those stars, those dead stars, because without them, we wouldn't be here.
That's right.
Told you that you was bought at a price before glorify God in your body. You know what I'm saying?
That's right.
So, I mean, these things are shown over and over again, you know, that we are literally stardust, you know. And here go the serpent in which that encases Heru. This is what they're talking about, the cobra. This is the serpent eating its tail here. This symbolizes the corona or our auric field around the body.
Yeah.
Right? It's called these particles, 90% of the human anatomy is composed of stardust particles. All right, these particles are called biophotons. These biophotons are called an ultra weak photonic emission and is light particles that is emitted by all living things. All right, so we are light beings, there's no doubt about it. You know what I'm saying? So we have to begin to start gathering more energy. And one of the techniques, the simplest technique to do so, is this right here. Hopefully, let me see, y'all can see me. Let me go back to the video for y'all can see me here. Okay. All right, so. All right. Your hands. Feet or shoulders. Your knees are slightly bent and your pelvis is slightly tilted forward.
Yes.
Your arm, you have an egg underneath your armpit. This is called Wu Qi. All right? Wu Qi means potential energy. So what you're going to do is breathe in as your arms come up. And as your hands come down, exhale.
Okay. Okay. Come straight up.
A lot of touch.
Okay. Inhale up, and exhale coming down.
Right.
Gotcha.
How long should we practice that, begin and off?
You can practice it as many times as you want to throughout the day. This is a grounding technique. And what it's doing is taking energy from the earth, bringing it up over top of your head, and bringing down the energy from the universe and connecting heaven to earth. And you ground the energy. So you're clearing out your chakra system at the same time, and then sending the negative energy into the earth.
Okay.
And filling up your cup, as they say, with the positive energy.
Okay.
This is qigong. All right?
Okay,
And this is what we need to be doing. We'll be outside calling on Betelgeuse or Betelgeuse is
being
hung in our Tai Chi at the same time. This is why they used to call us sun worshipers. because yeah. you know, the sun, and they would see us doing exercises such as yoga, qigong, or tai chi, mm-hmm. or whatever the case is, and they called us sun worshipers. You know, so this is what we have to do, y'all. All right?
All right. Yes, sir.
All right, we appreciate Brother Earnest, his divine mate there, Khamsin, for coming on, blessing us, giving us some of this deep information, and hopefully y'all got something from tonight's discussion, you know. We're going to do this again, y'all. This is not the first time, not the last time.
That's right.
See us, all right? So please go to their channel. Tell everybody your channel once again.
Spell my name.
It's Khamsin, Khamsin. That's on YouTube. And our website is www.remnantsgathering.com.
All right. Remnant.
And then, of course, we're on Instagram, just Remnants Gathering, and Facebook, Remnants Gathering.
Okay.
And do a Patreon too, guys.
Okay.
We sure need to.
Yeah. We're gonna get with y'all.
Yeah.
We're gonna get with y'all.
Okay.
But we appreciate
it. Yeah.
We gotta build up, rebuild our economy.
Yeah.
Within our people.
Exactly.
What you rappers, you what you crocheting? You making some jewelry?
Yeah, making some jewelry.
Okay. Yeah. Gotcha. Yeah. I gotta get on it too. Yeah. Oh, that looks lovely. Yeah.
Swamp with orders. So we are so grateful. We cannot say it enough. And we every dime.
Yeah. Y'all definitely our goals.
Yes.
You have kept us inspired and kept us reaching to do better and be better.
From the night y'all sent all of that mighty energy our way.
Yes.
Y'all remember a few years ago. Yeah. We felt it through the phone.
Oh.
Yeah.
Obviously, y'all was sending it back, and we grateful. You know, because y'all have now started inspiring us.
Yeah.
Wow. Well, thank you, sis. That's what we're here to do. Hopefully, we can just be examples to other people. You know, Black people, we don't have to keep hating each other. Regardless of what we believe, you know, hopefully unity and consciousness will be the result of them seeing a man and woman together and seeing what love looks like.
That's right.
As you stated, a remnants gathering.
Remnants. Yeah.
Remnants gathering.
We are the remnants.
Oh.
Gotcha.
Yeah.
In this 25,000 year renewal of history.
Oh.
That's right. Yeah.
Okay. All right, y'all. We appreciate y'all for coming out.
So much.
Brother Carbon, you know what I'm saying? Brother James, appreciate you. You know, who else is up in the building? Brother Robbie.
Fifth Element.
Milani.
Great job. Appreciate you. Thank you, Fifth Element.
Thank you in the comments.
You in here too.
Yeah.
James.
Look, peace, love, and Beetlejuice, not Hagrid.
Beetlejesus. Beetlejesus.
Thank you guys so much. Thank you so much.
Beetlejesus.
All right.
Okay, good night, y'all.
Good night. We'll be in touch.
Peace.
Okay.
Finish this playlist and we're done. Okay.